Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Emerald Hills. Beautiful day for some football. It's the U18 Western Challenge. And the first game is for the bronze medal. And the home team for today's game, Team BC. Treaty 6 territory, a traditional meeting grounds, gathering place, and traveling route to the Cree, Soto, Blackfoot, Métis, Dene, and Nakota Sioux. We acknowledge the many First Nations, Métis, and Inuit, whose footsteps have marked these lands. Could you please rise? Move your hats for the national anthem.
Welcome to the U18 Western Challenge bronze medal game at Emerald Hills here in Sherwood Park, Alberta, between Team Alberta White and Team BC. Connor Toffin here on the call, joined by Rob Harrod. Rob, we're going to get straight into it today. Biggest story over the weekend has obviously been the weather. You might see a little bit of that smoke. It's a hazy day here at Emerald Hills. Ended up having some Football Canada Cup games canceled yesterday. This game, if you're wondering why we're live at 10:30, it actually got pushed up by 30 minutes. So, Rob, what are the players dealing with on a day like today?
Well, there's lots going on in their minds, and they've got to remain focused on the task at hand. And, you know, we often talk to players about how they need to worry about what they can control. And unfortunately, game time, weather, smoke in the air, those are things that players cannot control. So if that occupies space in their minds, it's going to be a challenge for them, and it's going to present challenges for their team. But I think if the coaches have good conversations with their players, keep them focused, say, be ready to play when we're called upon. And this morning, they probably got a call as a decision was made, I think, shortly after 9 o'clock as to game time and all that stuff. And so I think, you know, over the last day, they'd probably be sitting on some of those things, keeping their focus and being prepared for whenever and if ever they get called to play.
Yeah, as of this morning, even waking up, coming here to call the game, I was doing my hair and I wasn't even sure if it was going to be played. And they end up moving the game up 30 minutes. It did rain a little bit last night, so that kind of helped a little bit. The smoke yesterday was at that 11-plus range where it's not even showing how bad it is anymore. So looked like it was going to last until today, but the smoke is kind of dispersed in the area a little bit here. This morning it was actually down to a 5. I believe they can play in anything at a 7 or lower. So they're going to keep monitoring it throughout the day. Now, switching topics here a little bit, Rob, these two teams lost on Thursday. It's a short tournament. They're playing just a few days later. How can a team look to change around the momentum so quickly after just a few days of rest?
Well, when you talk about these teams, they come from so many different high schools across their respective provinces, and so the chemistry needs to be built over time, and we saw that this week with the Canada Cup, and we're going to see it again with these players. Can they make the next step between their first game earlier in the week to this game, and how does that chemistry develop? And I think the team that's going to be the most successful on the field is the one that's able to do that the best, developing chemistry between quarterback, receiver, the front sevens of the defense and the secondary and their communication. I think the team that does that best and makes the biggest jump from this week's games to today's games is going to come out on top today.
So Team BC in the orange and black, Team Alberta White in the white and blue. Team BC going to be receiving the first kickoff, going to get the first crack at it on offense. Like I said, just a couple games in this showcase here, but a bronze medal on the line regardless today, so there is something to play for these two teams. Looks like Dawson Treen, out of Medicine Hat, if I got my number right, the jersey's got quite the tuck going on there, will be handling kickoff duties here for Team Alberta White. And we are underway here from Emerald Hills. Kick goes towards the sideline. That goes out of bounds and going to be an early flag here on Team Alberta for the illegal kick.
Well, it's going to be interesting to watch today how special teams impacts this game. They talk about offense, defense, and special teams as the three phases of the game. And early on, a kick out of bounds ends up putting BC in decent field position on the 40. And we'll see what their offense here can do with that field position.
As Rob said, BC will get possession at the 40. Chase Witzel lined up, starting the game at quarterback for Team BC. Out of Kelowna secondary. They're going to open up the game with a handoff, trying to take it out wide, trying to turn the corner now, and going nowhere for Team BC was Tom Jonas, also out of Kelowna Secondary High School. Good opening start here for the Team Alberta White defense.
You could see on there Jonas just waiting for the hole to pop open. He was patient, moving to the sideline. And again, Team Alberta's defense did a great job of stretching it to the sideline, eventually stopping him for no gain. And so the linemen are going to want to work on their hip position, and they're going to continue to try to move the holes and move bodies on the defense.
Ball only moved up a couple of inches from the previous spot, if that. Dropping pass to pass, Witzel, it's a completion. Team BC with a big play here for the first down. They're going to get it. Cooper Groneveld with the reception and the yak yards. That one's going to go for over 20 yards and a first down for BC.
Well, and you can see in the replay there, you just saw that the halfback, Daniel Kalani, I think, from Harry Ainley High School, was working to the flat there, just out of his reach, though, that ball, and as he tried to undercut it, allowing BC to secure the first down.
So BC moving the chains here, just a minute and a half into this game. Another handoff here to Jonas, middle of the line of scrimmage again. Jonas churning out some extra yards. He's going to pick up a gain of a few on first down.
Already early on, you're seeing the front seven of Alberta be pretty strong against the run game, forcing BC into the pass. And again, You know, just kind of watching the warm-up, BC looked like they enjoyed throwing the ball, so we'll see. Obviously want to keep a balance on offense, but we'll see if they continue to go to the air to move this ball.
Second and seven here for Chase Witzel and Team BC. He's looking right. Pressure being brought. There's a flag on the play, but a sack regardless. Kingston Pritchard with the sack for Team Alberta White. We'll check the flag, though. And it's going to go against Team Alberta White.
So, again, you can see BC, they emptied the backfield in that case, kept one back in to block as he did a little bit of a half roll. Just couldn't find a receiver wide open, and pressure got to him. But fortunately, it looks like the holding penalty was against BC, which makes a little bit more sense in the backfield. And so it's going to be third and 12.
Looked like the head official might have just pointed the wrong way there. And so it's actually going to be a third and 12 and a half or so. That's probably going to set up Team BC for a punting down here. They'll blow it dead. Play clock stops, so BC with a little bit of extra time here. Get that special teams unit on the field.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting if they charge BC a timeout. It looks like they called the timeout to get the change. But again, the confusion came because the call on the field was that it was against Alberta. So BC was thinking, oh, first down, away we go. Good situation. Unfortunately, they had to make that switch and get their punt team on the field.
Definitely was a team timeout on BC there, so that's going to cost them a little bit. BC's going to be punting here from their own 48-yard line. Always interesting to see what kind of kickers and punters they have at these type of tournaments here. A lot of the times in high school, teams don't even roster a kicker or a punter. You'll see a wide receiver in there handling the kicking duties. And sometimes at tournaments like this, you can get some pretty special legs.
Yeah, and it's totally true. And sometimes with these teams, you know, when they start picking different U18 teams, and this would be BC's second team, you know, if there is a kicker, he may be on the first team, and is there even a second kicker available? And so usually it's your best athlete out there doing their job.
Snap was wide there, but there was whistles on the play. I don't think play was ever whistled in. Andrew Lawson going to be punting the ball away here for Team BC on this delayed punting play. It's going to take a few minutes to get it off here, but it'll happen. So we'll see what kind of leg Andrew Lawson has. Low punt. Going to work out here for Team BC as it bounces over the returner. Alberta's going to take it inside their own five. Taking it wide, looking for a return here is Terrell Hoffman. Just gets outside of his own 10, where the Team Alberta White offense is going to start.
Well, so far we're seeing BC move the ball a little bit, obviously on that one reception, and then a great punt with a good result in the end. And so Alberta's moving, going to be starting deep in their own end, and we'll see how if they can flip the script on field position early on in this game as they're pinned pretty deep.
Team Alberta. A little bit of a wide snap there for quarterback Josh Martel. They're going to run it wide and get it down to about the 15.
So short run on the game. You can see again trying to stretch the field. And you're starting to see just the chemistry and where there's little mishaps. And we've seen a couple times on that last punt. Again, even the second snap was a little bit wide, corralled by the punter. And that time, snap was a little bit high from Team Alberta. So timing is a little off when those things happen.
Josh Martel out of Bishop Carroll High School in Calgary. We're going to go with the handoff again to Matthew Sitton. Sorry, that was a play action. Fooled me. And couldn't quite connect with the receiver there. Punt unit going to come on here for Team Alberta.
Yeah, really nice play action, as you had mentioned. Unfortunately, in the hands of the wide open receiver and just play now dropped. And so, you know, he'd love to get that one back because he'd be off to the races with a lot of space out there. Again, play action is really important. If you can get the run game going a little bit, and then you can start drawing in the front seven, what happens is the linebackers end up, you know, taking 2-3 steps towards a run, and by the time they recognize the quarterback's got the ball, away they go.
Nate Oss is currently lined up on side here for Team Alberta, backed up on their own goal line. We'll see if they take the safety. They'll back up a couple yards. And what do you think of the call there for Team Alberta? Just a few minutes in here taking the safety.
Well, it's early in the game, and so again, you know, a lot comes down to your punter, and can your punter drop it 45 yards and get him out of there? And so coaching philosophy will, you know, change between personnel and who they feel they have that can do it. But again, in that case, taking the safety, I think it was a good call. You know, getting the field position flipped a little bit. But again, BC's back on offense, and again, with a couple first downs, they may be in the same situation. So we'll see how that plays out over the course of the day, but I think it's a decent call to take the safety that deep, knowing, you know, again, we talked about, you know, the layers of players here, and this is Team Alberta's third team, so they have three, and so again, the talent is spread over those three teams, so whether they have a punter that can get out of their own end is we don't know yet. So
BC takes it on their own 35, coming off the safety. They'll take a 2-0 lead here early. Another running play here for BC. It looked like Matt Chapman taking it right up the gut, going to get a few yards on the first down play.
Yeah, we're saying BC, again, be consistent with that run game. Try to get some first down production. Again, not bad. 3 yards on first down's okay. But again, the front seven of Alberta really seems to be in the gaps on defense, really limiting the ability to run the ball. So coming out with five receivers, we see BC here. We'll see what they do here on second and long.
Three to the left, going to be a screen play. There's a flag on the play as well as they find Chapman again. Chapman lowers the shoulder. And he's going to be stopped a few yards short of the first down marker. A flag on the far side as well.
Yeah, you can see the bench right in front of the play react to the finish of that play. Some good contact there between two great athletes trying to make plays. And so we're going to see what this call is here.
See that stiff arm there. Strong play there by Matthew Chapman. So penalty here was against Team Alberta. So BC going to get to keep it second down and gain an extra yard than they did on the play. It'll be a second and two from the 48-yard line.
Well, in a great situation to be in. Again, you can play action, you can run the ball, and you can throw it here as well. So you got pretty much everything at your disposal.
Tom Jonas in the backfield, they're going to fake it to him. Throw just sails over the receiver, and a huge hit delivered over the middle by James Drake. That was Logan Rubel, the intended receiver.
Well, you can see him a little slow to get up, and now there he takes a knee again, shot in the back. Again, you're kind of exposed over the middle as you're going up for that high ball, and unfortunately he took a shot right in his back, and so sure he'll be okay. I'll wish him the best as he walks himself off the field. Again, just needs a little bit of a breather. I'm sure he's going to want to get back on there pretty quickly.
Might have actually been Boston McCory there on the hit. Out of Austin O'Brien High School. Just a little bit away in Edmonton. As a commentator, I think tuck jerseys should be legal, Rob.
Yeah, they roll them up. It's sometimes hard to see. And again, you know, you're dealing with jerseys that are ordered long before these teams are even made, and they got to fit properly of different size kids and different height kids. So great punt there by BC again.
That's a good punt there. Off the foot of Andrew Lawson. Team Alberta having some trouble picking it up, and we'll see what they can get in the return. Trying to take it to the outside is Terrell Hoffland. And about a 10-yard return there, not too bad considering where they were at. He throws the ball on the ground. Got to be careful. That could have been a penalty there, Rob.
Yeah, you got to keep your head. We've seen a pretty disciplined game so far. A few penalties, but not too costly yet. But again, now we look back at that safety that Alberta gave up. And their defense came up big with the stop. But right now, I would still say that from a special team standpoint, BC's punting game has been pretty good. We've had two good punts already, and so gaining a little bit of field position through special teams, and we'll see what Alberta's offense has on their second series.
Josh Martel at quarterback, going to fake the handoff once again, rolling out to his right, feeling the pressure. He's going to throw it on the run, and just out of the reach of the receiver, Riley Hutton.
Yeah, again, coming back to play action again. BC was a little bit more on that time, and you can see they flushed the quarterback out. Didn't have the clear vision, but also didn't have a receiver wide open. So he tried to throw the receiver open by throwing it a little bit behind him into the open space, which is good for a quarterback to understand, hey, let's try to get him to an open space because where he was going was not open. So we'll see what they have here on second and 10.
Probably going to have to look to the air here with four receivers to the right, one to the left. Martel going deep down the sideline. Is that caught? It is. What a pitch and catch for Team Alberta. as Josh Martell and James Drake find the connection.
Well, and again, you're exactly right. Great connection down the sideline. I like the early decision of Alberta to take a shot deep again. Talk about the progression of a game. You want to make sure that the secondary and the defense on both these teams know you're willing to go deep. If you're going to creep to the line of scrimmage, really attack the play action in the run game, we're going to go over the top. And there's a great example of Alberta taking that shot early and it coming out in favor of them.
So fresh set of sticks here for Team Alberta. Now with the BC 52. We're going to go with the sweep here to the receiver, Terrell Hofflin. Crosses the 45, and he's going to be shot just short of a first down, but real good first down production there for the team in white.
Yeah, great first down production. That's exactly what you want. As you see him come across on the sweep, you can see lead blocker out in front. He's got to make a decision and go get him. Again, if he goes gets the first guy, they probably get the first down instead of a second and one here. Now, I'm sure, you know, we're early on, but we're already talking like three down football right now. I mean, Alberta wants to continue this drive and move it, so they're probably fully committed to making sure they convert this first down. We'll see if they go to the run here on second and very short.
They are going to go to the run. Not going to be a huge gain. Falling forward with Matthew Siddle. It's going to be tight here on the sticks. I'm not sure he got enough.
Yeah, I think he ended up, his knee ended up going down before he finished falling forward. So I think the spot's right, and they're still yards short. They may even have lost a few inches there on that one. So we'll see. As I said, you know, likely committed to going for it here. And interesting. It's always an interesting debate. And we've seen it many times here in Edmonton with the Elks over the first course of their season. All these first and one, second and one, and not converting. And do you go in shotgun with the regular quarterback in your regular offense? You bring in, you know, a different quarterback to run something under center? Do you just run a quarterback sneak and rely on your guys? And, you know, you're weighing out a lot of factors when it comes to that. And in this case, you know, you're weighing out your offensive line versus the defensive line of BC. What does that look like for you? Do you feel like that's an advantage? And if you feel like you have an advantage in the trenches there, as we would say with the offense and defensive line, you may just line up under center and go quarterback sneak. In this case, on second and one, you could see them in the shotgun. They end up lining up, and it wasn't successful. They ended up getting no gain there. We'll see what they do here on third and one.
Team Alberta White ended up taking the timeout there, so we'll see what they have drawn up. Important play here early on in the game in the first quarter. If BC can force the turnover, they'll get the ball back in pretty good field position. And Team Alberta gonna have a real good chance to score if they can convert. They're gonna move Martell under center. He is gonna sneak it, and looks like he's got more than enough for the first down.
Yeah, you can see the defense came pretty hard. Contact happened, but he just kept fighting and spun for the first down. And great job of Alberta converting that to keep this drive alive. Now just outside the 40 going in.
Had about a yard to spare on there, so pick up a 2 on the quarterback sneak. And a new fresh set of downs here for Alberta at the Team BC 41. Not sure what field goal range would be yet. Martell over the middle, looking for the receiver, and there's a flag. James Drake drew it. Looks like BC made a little bit of early contact there on the throw.
Yeah, we'll get a great chance on the replay here to see this. As you can see, the ball's delivered in a great spot, but contact happens right there. And again, it's about a step, step and a half early. Good call by the officials to see that contact, throw the flag, and Alberta's going to get deep into the zone here.
That was Connor Schick in coverage. Remember, high school rules, those pass interferences aren't spot of foul penalties. 15 yarders though, so still costly. And now Team Alberta moving it to the BC 26 yard line. Matthew Siddle in the backfield. Martell going to the end zone. Touchdown, Team Alberta. James Drake once again.
So great play call after Alberta gets the PI going deep, feeling maybe we got an advantage here in the secondary and giving the receiver a shot. And I love the call because it just gives that guy some confidence, gives the receiver confidence, like, hey, we believe in you. We're going to send this to the end zone. You go make a play for this team. And of course, in the end zone, goes up, brings the ball down. Great job, great way to convert that great drive into a major.
James Comstock out to try and kick the extra point. He might be the holder, rather. It'll be Dawson Trino trying to kick the extra point, rather. Man, looking at the replay there, too. That was really close. James Drake just getting that toe. Inbounds. And Team Alberta able to capitalize, picking up the full seven off the extra point.
Yeah, solid contact, good kick on that. But as you'd mentioned, that touchdown catch, I mean, receivers work on that so often where they're just on the sideline working to get a foot in, and that's what they want to do. And so they got to get their feet in bounds. And the refs believe, based on what they saw, that he had his feet in bounds, and it's a completed catch. So it's a touchdown, Alberta. They take the lead after conceding the safety to work the field position and making that choice. It seems like it's worked out in their favor so far.
And James Drake with a couple big catches on that drive, plus drawing the pass interference. Probably going to be a name to watch the rest of the way through here, Rob.
Yeah, and you look for those matchups, and you start to, as the course of the game moves on, you start to see the matchups where you can maybe expose a weakness. You know, often in football, you're going to be looking at film and studying. On a short tournament play like this, you don't have a whole lot of film or time to watch that.
Pretty decent kickoff here for Team Alberta. Going to be taken by Cooper Groneveld. Trying to take it to the outside. He'll cross the 35 and get taken down to the 37, where the Team BC offense will get their third crack at it.
Well, great return by BC again. What happened on that kickoff is it didn't get a lot of hang time. Although it was a decent kick deep, it didn't get the hang time. So what that does for a kickoff team is the cover team can't get downfield quick enough. And that actually gave BC the opportunity because they caught the ball in the air and on the run. Great little return for BC and good starting field position for their offense.
Chase Witzel will take over at his own 37. They're going to fake the handoff. Witzel out left into traffic, and it's caught. This is a big play here for Logan Rubel and Team BC. Rubel fighting off the defender and finally taken down inside the Team Alberta 35. What a play for Team BC.
Yeah, and he threw it into a tight window there. You can see on the replay as he rolls out. He sees his receiver just coming open. He throws it before he's open, hits him in stride. And that's the same receiver that took a shot with a little bit of a high ball earlier. And again, back with a vengeance. Solid, solid receiver. Great run after the catch and willing to just not run out of bounds, but put his head down and just keep going forward.
We'll get out of the shotgun here. Witzel under center and now on the handoff. Fighting off of a couple defenders there. Was Tom Jonas, I believe? No, that was new player into the game, Xander Tabara. And a good first down gain there for Team BC of 9.
Yeah, great back out of Prince George. Again, just real slippery in the backfield there on that run, just kind of eluding some tackles as he slid right next to kind of a pile of defense and offensive guys. Great job, good production on first down, obviously.
Just one to go here. They're gonna go to the air. Witzel, oh, wide! And Tabara was the intended receiver. He was looking for a flag there as well on the hit. Not going to get one.
Well, it was interesting watching that play kind of progress on the back end there. As the DB, the free safety coming up, was looking at the receiver. Didn't even look at the ball. Again, the ball was slightly overthrown. May have actually had a play on the ball if he would have spotted the ball. But again, going for the hit. And he's going to have to watch that because that's two hits on receivers. And again, safety is always going to be important.
They're going to pitch it here on third and one, and they're in trouble. Team Alberta White's going to force the stop. A loss of a few for Team BC. And what a play for the Team Alberta D-line.
Wow, front seven play is going to be absolutely critical all day long, and that was a huge play. Again, interesting, though, when you think about the progression of that game, you see BC on second and one. Instead of going for it, getting a quarterback sneak, getting the first down, they take a shot downfield, and it was overthrown, and then they get stuck in third and one, and, of course, the front seven of Alberta stepped up huge to turn the ball over.
So Team Alberta, fresh off of a touchdown by James Drake. He's lined up at the bottom of your screen. They're going to start this drive with a run here by Matthew Siddle, and not a lot there. If anything at all, he's going to end up picking up a loss of two.
Well, on great first down response from the BC defense. You can hear the bench down here in front of us getting pretty excited about it and getting those guys riled up and going. And really trying to make up for that turnover on downs and see if they can do the same or at least force a punting situation here on second and what looks to be about 12 and a half.
Big play here for the Team Alberta defense, fresh off the turnover on downs. Snap is high here, flag on the play as well. It's gonna be blown dead. And might be a procedure here on Team Alberta. A time count.
Yeah, it's gonna make it a little bit longer of a second down. They're now gonna be looking at second and 17, I guess, if it goes back five. So a definite passing down. But what's helping Alberta out right now is so far they've found success in their mismatches in the secondary. And so I definitely think Alberta will take a nice shot deep. You know, I know sometimes you opt to do something safe, but I think something deep will be good. And
gonna throw it underneath here to Terrell Hofflin. Not a bad idea. Get it to your kick returner. He's made a couple of guys miss already in today's game. Nice, safe throw in the flats there. Try to get a couple guys to miss, and in the end, about a 10-yard gain there on second down.
Yeah, great gain. Unfortunately, just not enough, and that's what BC's defense was trying to do, is keep it underneath, force them to come to a check down or something like that. And so good job of BC after their offense couldn't convert their short downage. They're going to get the ball back here after this punt.
Is that Josh Martell back to punt as well? Snap is high. Martell back into his own end zone and smartly just gets on top of it and concedes the safety. There are some BC defenders in the area.
Yeah, well, special teams continues to play into this game a little bit here. Again, another malfunction on Alberta's special teams with the high snap, another couple points given up. And so BC's offense, again, back a little bit more in their own end because of the field position. But again, some points on the board. The draws with one a little bit closer. And of course, BC now on offense with, again, a chance to move the ball. We'll see what they do. Again, they had a little bit of success on the run, but again, keeping it balanced is going to be important this early on to keep Alberta guessing. But that front seven of Alberta has been pretty stiff against the run so far today.
Probably their most success so far has been finding Logan Rubel. He's in the slot to the right of the quarterback. New quarterback into the game as well is Liam Connolly. Good run here on first down for Team BC. A pickup of 13, and finally Team Alberta able to drag him out of bounds.
Yeah, great job of bouncing it outside as he went to attack the hole. You could see it a little bit congested, but saw the space on the outside, so just bounced out there. And a great job to the receivers out there. They took their DBs deep, which is what created so much running room there. And so, you know, as a receiver, you have a couple options on a run play. Usually you tell them they can go and block their guy, and they got a stock block for a fair bit of time, or they can run them off. But you don't want to try to run them off and then lose your DB. In that case, they did a great job getting up deep to create some running room.
As I said, Connolly now the new quarterback into the game for Team BC. They're gonna run it here on first down. A little bit of a hesitation there for Matthew Chapman, but that opens up a hole, and they're gonna get about 7 or 8. There is a flag on the play coming somewhere in the secondary.
Yeah, and usually that comes on a run play in the area of holding. I think I saw her. The indication early on was that it could possibly be holding. So we'll see if that's what it is. And indeed, it is holding. So great first down run, unfortunately, for BC. They're going to be moving it back. And we've got an injured BC player just gone down here. Training staff's coming to take a look.
Looks like lineman Sean Yin is down. I believe that should have been the last play of the first quarter, as well as the clock hit zeros before that ball was snapped. Check that in a bit as trainers are out to look at Sean Yin. Well, Rob, like I said before the game, the biggest story yesterday was the smoke. Woke up this morning and it was at a 5. It seems to be getting a little more hazy here at Emerald Hills, but just checked my phone here and they have the air quality still at just a 6. So still safe to play in and legal to play in under Team Alberta or Football Alberta rules.
Yeah, and I had a chance to work with Tim Enger around the six-man All-Star game earlier in the spring, and we dealt with similar conditions where it was kind of on and off. We had to cancel some practices for the players. And again, player safety is of the utmost importance. But again, with elite level sport, which I believe these games this week are qualified on, you actually have a little more leeway as long as it's under 10 is, I think, the standard. But again, it's a classification of what kind of sporting competition it is. If it's, you know, recreation, high school, it's different. And again, this is elite level provincial play, and so there's a little bit of leeway in that. Of course, they are constantly monitoring that for the safety of the players, and we'll have to make the decision if the time comes today.
I was actually really impressed yesterday with how it was handled by Football Canada. It's an unfortunate scenario all around. Talk about it more at the quarter break. A first and 20 here for Team BC. Connolly with the pass out right. Quick hitter there to Rubel, and that'll pick up about five. Not enough to get back to the original line of scrimmage, and that'll be the end of the first quarter here. As BC will flip sides of the field and then go to a second and 15. Well, Rob, you were involved in it yesterday, like I talked about, and just kind of continuing the conversation here on the smoke. Supposed to have some Canada Cup games yesterday down at Commonwealth Stadium, and there was a lot of movement. I mean, the gold medal game went from 7 p.m. to 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. to 3 p.m. to 8:30 to canceled. And I'm sure these players had an eye on it. And I know I was a little fearful of the same thing happening today, where, like, yesterday I drove to Commonwealth three different times to go call the game, and just good to see some football being played here today.
Well, it is, and it's great. And these guys are excited. They've traveled a long way. They've put a lot of work, time, and energy, and, you know, families have come a long ways to see these guys play. So it is great. It was great news this morning, waking up knowing the conditions of the air was better today and that football could get played.
So long set of downs here for Team BC to open up the second quarter as they flip sides. Second down and 15 here for Liam Connolly and his offense. Team BC looked like they were way offside. They're going to go deep to Rubel, throw just a bit behind him. And if that is a offside on Team BC, likely to be declined here, and punt team should come on the field.
Yeah, we'll see what happens. I think you're right. I think BC, the receivers have been really pushing the limit of running at the line of scrimmage. So, of course, in Canadian football, if you're not on the line of scrimmage, you can attack the line of scrimmage and run at. But the rule is you should be off the line of scrimmage on the snap. And I noticed a few times in the first quarter that they were really, really close to that limit, maybe a little bit offside. Again, if you watch much CFL, often you'll see receivers attack the line of scrimmage. They give them usually a step, actually. And a lot of times it's like they're a step over the line. But, you know, the rules allow for that that kind of gray area of officiating, and so they make the call, and they're pretty consistent on that in the CFL. In high school football, there's maybe a little less leeway. They want to teach those kids to attack the line properly, and so I've seen them close, and I think they got caught on that one, even though it was an incomplete pass. We'll watch that over the course of the game.
Looked like the timing might have been off on that one as well. As a few receivers over the line of scrimmage. Team BC's they've had some good punts so far, but this one's going to be a shank, bouncing it around midfield. Team Alberta does end up recovering, and another mistake there for Team BC is they line up within that 5 yards. It'll be in no yards as well.
Yeah, so special teams going in favor of Alberta. Didn't do a lot special on that punt return, but taking advantage of the short kick and great heads-up play just jumping on the ball, because often on a short kick like that, what you'll find is your kicker can get downfield, and on a bad kick he's like, oh, I'm going to see if I can make up for that, get downfield. He can actually recover the ball, but just great job of being secure, jumping on the ball, and getting their offense on the field and in great field position already in BC territory.
So Team Alberta up 7-4. Get another chance on offense here, starting best starting field position of the day for Team Alberta. Couple pitches there, and a bit of a trickery here for Team Alberta as they get the ball into the hands of Terrell Hoffland. Ends up being just a gain of four, but like the creativity there from Team Alberta.
Well, what that does is, again, yeah, decent gain on first down, but it keeps the backside of the defense honest. And so often what you're going to see is the defensive linemen or linebackers that are responsible for the backside of a play like that will start to chase. And if they chase too aggressively on, like, a front side run, that's how you attack the backside. So although, yes, got some positive yards, great play call, it's also going to keep that defense honest and allow them to pursue the front side run just a little less aggressively.
James Comstock into the game at quarterback for Team Alberta out of Medicine Hat High School. High snap, able to handle it. He's just going to pull it down and maybe not quite get back to the line of scrimmage there. But Rob, I think that was a good decision there by Comstock.
Yeah, just to maintain possession was important there. Again, very lucky, just off the fingertips, was able to kind of pull it in the second time around. And again, good job of securing that. Again, they gained some field position on the short punt. What we didn't want to see is either a turnover from Alberta's perspective or a play that lost a lot of yards. So good job of just getting what he could, securing the ball, playing that field position battle right now, getting their punt team on. Hopefully for Alberta, they can pin him deep. Maybe BC can flip it with a nice big special teams return.
Low snap there. Martel bobbled it. And a low punt there. Going to roll into the end zone. And Team BC probably going to have to take a symbol. It's fumbled! And BC just has to recover. Boy, almost a bounce there for Team Alberta. If they would have recovered it, that's a touchdown.
Yeah, that could have been a big game changer right there. Again, the punt goes into the end zone. And BC will... We'll get their offense back on the field here. Again, giving up the single. Makes it 9-4. 9-4. Sorry, the safety makes it 9-4. So we'll see. No.
They have 9-4 on the scoreboard. I don't think... If Team BC touches it out of the end zone, it would be a safety. There we go. They moved it down to 8-4. Okay, so it is just a single.
Yeah, just the single there, as we suspected, but wanted to make sure the scoreboard reflected that. So 8-4. Interesting football score when you think about possibilities. It's not one you'd take at the quarter time, but we'll see what BC can do here, starting on the 35.
We had no more points. This could be a score origami. I don't know if you've ever heard of that, Rob. But this could be. This is a score. I don't know if I've ever seen it before. Run out to the left for Team BC. Good first down yardage there for Matthew Chapman, finding some room on that left side of the line.
Yeah, great first down production. Again, BC not panicking. I mean, they're only down four. There's lots of football left to play in this game. So just continue to establish that run, and we'll see if they can keep it going here. Good production of 8 yards on first down with the run.
Second down and just two for Team BC. Similar yardage to a set of downs in the first half where Team Alberta was able to come up with the stops. See if Team BC can improve here. They're going to fake the handoff and a throw all wide. Good yardage here for BC as they find Groneveld. He'll have the first down and a few more as play is whistled down.
Yeah, great pursuit by Alberta's defense. Unfortunately, it was after the completion and the yards they needed. So, but I like them coming hard. Alberta continues to battle on defense, trying to get the edge here for their team. They've got a four-point lead right now, and the defense is on the field. But BC is starting to move the ball. We'll see if they can continue this drive.
Ball at the 51-yard line for BC, and a bit of a snap count there for BC. Not sure who that was on. I think this is going to go against Team Alberta, but we'll see if someone jumped, as the officials are going to huddle up and discuss.
It comes down to who did the officials see move first. Clearly there's a couple defensive guys, and BC decided to go on two, which worked out hopefully in their favor, as long as one of the offensive guys didn't flinch. But there is a conversation as to, did anybody see the offensive guys move? And so that's the conversation they're having right now. If the offensive guys move at all, or the ball moves at all, and that causes the defense to jump, it would be on the offense and it would be procedure. If it's the defense that moved because of the snap count, does look like it's going to be against BC. So someone must have seen an offensive lineman move on that one, and it goes against BC, moving them back.
I always think that's a bigger conversation than maybe you realize. It's a difference of 10 yards there on that decision between a first and 5 and first and 15.
Well, the rule is that as an offensive lineman, once you're set in your position, your hand is down, you are not allowed to move. And, you know, again, in high school, they try to coach and give you a little bit of leeway, but ultimately, once your hand is down, you need to be perfectly still. And so if you rise up, you bob your head, any of those movements is actually enough to cause a procedure penalty. And so somewhere in the mix there, we would have seen one of the refs definitely saw movement on the offensive side.
So BC behind the chains here, first and 15. Connolly with his second series in at quarterback. He'll fake the handoff. Connolly looking deep. What an air under that ball. Receiver having to turn around, and Alberta nearly coming up with the interception. It was off the fingertips of Caden Semro.
Yeah, a lot of conversation going on. And again, right in front of the BC bench. Concerned about some pass interference. We'll check it out on the replay.
We didn't see anything. Ball was behind the receiver. I don't know, Rob. In my mind, that's kind of a fight for the football there when it's thrown that far back.
Yeah, it was. I think what the bench was seeing is 12 looked like he had his hand on his back as he fought back for the ball. And we tell receivers all the time, look to fight back to the ball.
Good job by the BC receiver there to even make that a conversation. Quick hitter here for Team BC down the sideline. Pickup of 10 and a huge hit at the end. And is that going to draw a flag here? That was Groeneveld on the catch. And I didn't see if that hit might have came in a bit high.
Yeah, I think what they saw was helmet-to-helmet contact. And when you come in as a defender, you cannot... The initial contact cannot be your helmet on their helmet or your shoulder pad on the receiver's helmet or running back's helmet, and I think that's what he saw. It was pretty clear on the replay. He was kind of coming on that angle, and that's where, you know, as a high school player, they're learning to tackle properly, and that is continually gets taught at all levels. And again, we want to keep football a safe game to play, and learning those techniques properly is going to be important. And you wish you had that one back because it was good aggression, good defensive play other than just the finish.
That's Wyatt Cooley picking up the flag. So rather than a 3rd and 5, 15-yard penalty and a fresh set of downs here for Team BC at the Alberta 40. And a good gain on first down there for Tom Jonas. Looked like he was going to pick up some more, but a pretty good tackle there.
Well, this offense continues to move both through the air and on the ground. Again, still looking for the first touchdown for BC of the day, but they're in great position here. It's 2nd and 5. If they can keep balanced and keep production going like they have on this drive, obviously aided by the penalty, that could result in some points here for BC.
2nd down and 5. Huge play. BC out there in field goal range quite yet. It'll be a 42-yarder from here. Connolly, deep shot, looking for Rubel, lots of contact, and no flag. Rubel wants one, and the BC bench wants one, and I think they have an argument.
Well, let's take a look at this replay here as it plays out.
See that ball thrown inside the 10, and tough there for Rubel. Looked like he might have had a hand tied up.
It looked like he did have a hand tied up, so I understand why the complaint is coming from the BC bench, but I think...
Late flag here, by the way, down at the 15. I wonder if this is on BC here for the talk afterwards, and it is against Team BC.
Well, it came from deep from the officials in the secondary there, so they must have heard something or maybe something said from the bench, not sure, but... Definitely an interesting play because I think there was definitely contact. But the one thing I would say to Rubel is as he kind of got to the end of that, he kind of threw his hands up a little like he was trying to get the call without making a play on the ball. If he turns and tries to actually go make a play on the ball, I think he gets the flag because there was contact there. It's whether or not it was close enough and directed at the right place in the right time.
Low snap here. And good job getting the punt away there from Andrew Lawson. Bit of a fumble here for Team Alberta. They pick it up. And a bit of a return here brought just outside around the 30-yard line for Hoffman. Now, the other thing there, too, is that flag after the play. BC was going to go for it on their own 35, or on Alberta's 35, rather, on a 3rd and 5. The 10-yard penalty forces them to punt, and now Alberta gets it on their own 27.
Yeah, we don't know who that penalty was on. It could have been on the bench. It could have been on one of the players for, you know, obviously disagreeing with the call. But again, that's one of those things we talked about earlier in the game about the smoke and the weather. It's out of your control, and you can't control the officials. And as a player, I know it's hard. You're passionate. You're excited to be playing. You want to make sure you kind of keep that level head and not get into arguments. Or as a bench, you want to make sure you don't cost your team yards like they did there.
5.5 minutes left here in the second quarter where Team Alberta takes over. Matthew Siddle churning out some extra yards. Picks up maybe over half the yardage he'll need there for the first down.
Yeah, definitely good first down yardage there on the toss. And again, you can see he opened. The quarterback opens to the right and tosses it to the left. So, again, you're trying to create, be deceiving with the defense. You open to the right thinking we're going that direction. They may take a couple steps, but as the toss comes back the other way, gives them a little bit more leverage on the defense. Great first down production.
Second down and 5. Quarterback under center. They'll fake the pitch. A quick give to the tight end. And that one's going absolutely nowhere. Team BC with a big stop. And that should force Team Alberta to punt.
Ben Shepherd did a great job of staying disciplined in his gap as he kind of filled the backside gap there and didn't over-pursue or didn't come down the line of scrimmage chasing that toss action. But the counter came right to his hole and he was there to secure that. Great job of BC's defense securing a 3-and-out here and forcing a punt situation.
Team Alberta has had some struggles punting so far. This snap much better than one of them earlier. Angled punt here, gonna bounce around midfield. And BC, their returner kind of dove at it there as it took a weird bounce. And good read there by Matt Chapman as he's gonna force no yards here.
Yeah, I'd like to see these returners a little bit more aggressive on the return team. Again, you can see the first bounce of that football went nice and high, and that would have been the opportune time for that returner just to jump on that, catch it on the run, get a few yards. Again, still secured it, decent field position on the short kick. But again, over the course of this game, I'd like to see those returners just step up and be aggressive. Catching that ball on the run, as we've seen a little bit today, is super critical for the return game. It doesn't allow coverage to get down nearly as quickly. So we'll see what BC can do here back on offense.
BC gets it to their own 54. Under 4 minutes remaining in the quarter. Quick screen as they find Groneveld. He picks up a bunch of yak yards, 15 yards in the first down for BC.
Well, you could see Logan Rubble out in front blocking for him. Didn't actually get a great block, but what a great run. Taking contact, continuing to move his legs, and getting a first down yardage needed to move the sticks. But great effort by the receiver just moving downfield and taking on some tackles and really setting the tone, really bringing some physicality to the offensive side of the ball.
Ball at the Alberta 42. Lots of time here for BC in the quarter. Connolly pulls it, and he's got some good yardage down the middle, across the 30, and finally taken down. Haven't seen the quarterback scramble too much today from either side, but Connolly picks up a big first down here as Team BC marches it within the 30.
Well, what they did there is they came back to that wide receiver screen, but they called the screen and go. Or they called the fake screen, and they had Rubble down the sideline. And again, great coverage by Alberta's defense to stay with that. And so by doing that, they forced him to pull it down and run. Now, great run, of course, as we just saw. But they were looking for the end zone shot on that one. We'll see if they come back with another deep shot here on first and 10 inside the 30.
3 minute warning whistled in. Connolly to the air. Into the flats, and nice hands there by Rubel. It's a nice catch. It's only going to go for about 2 yards, but impressive catch nonetheless.
Well, right down, 6-8 inches off the ground, gets his hands down there, snags it before it touches the turf. Again, great catch, a gain of 3 yards. That's though where you want your quarterback, just to be able to lead him to the sideman. Obviously, the ball a little bit higher allows your big, strong receiver to catch that and turn up field and not force him to go down and pick that off the turf.
Second down and about 7.5. Early movement there for Team Alberta. There is a flag. Might be a shot play here for BC. And lots of contact there in the end zone. Falls, pass is going to fall incomplete, and we'll check the flag. There's a little bit of early movement from Team Alberta, but must have been an O-lineman moving first. Penalty is going to go against BC.
Yeah, and BC, I think, was hoping for maybe a flag on the back end of that, and that could have offset the offside and get another shot here, but they did not get the pass interference call, and I think the reason it wasn't thrown was because the receiver, I think, had his foot on the line out of bounds prior to both the ball arriving and any contact happening there. So he took himself out of the play by stepping out of bounds there, and so we'll see if the BC's special teams field goal unit can convert this with some points.
Andrew Lawson out to attempt a 32-yard field goal. There is a returner back for Alberta, and this one's going to go wide. Takes a bounce about 5 yards into the end zone, and now an opportunity for Alberta on the return. Taking it across the 10. And overall, good coverage there for Team BC. There is a flag on the field and a player down for BC as well. And this could be a big flag. I didn't see if that was on the return or on the kick there, Rob.
Yeah, not sure. We're going to have to see here. And we also got an Alberta guy on the far sideline down.
Looked like that blindside block right there. Or crackback block, rather, over the middle of the field. That one's going to go against Team Alberta all day. I don't know if you caught that, Rob.
Yeah, they're going to be moving it back here. So that's going to put them deep in their own end. And we'll see how they respond to get a little bit of adversity. That's what football games are about.
That penalty.
Yeah, so again, one of the new rules put in the last couple of years is what we call a blindside block, where a guy is kind of in pursuit. And the rule basically is you're not allowed to block a defender back towards your own goal line. So in that case, you could see the Alberta guy coming back towards that direction. As he pursues to the edge of the field, he's not watching. A very dangerous play. Again, not intentional, but again, that's just an effort thing where he's trying to get a block. And there's new techniques now that we're teaching football players to kind of cut him off in different ways. And again, often when contact happens with your shoulder pad or, of course, the helmet, as we talked about earlier, on a guy like that, keeping it a safe game is important. And that's why they have those rules in place. And so, again, making sure players stay safe is important, and teaching that technique to these guys as they're young, because you know a lot of these guys are aspiring football players to play at maybe the CIS level and trying to improve their game. And so learning happens, of course, at all levels. But these young guys, some of these guys have only been playing football for, you know, a year or two or three. Some haven't played their whole life, so lots to learn in the game of football. And of course, the game always changes a little bit, and new rules come in, and new things need to be learned. So learning is constantly happening. Still, the BC player is down on the field. They're checking him out. I believe the Alberta guy has made it off to the sidelines, so he seems to be in okay shape. And we'll see how BC does here, and we'll wish him, of course, the best, as we want to see him back on the field later today.
I wasn't able to catch a number for the Team BC player down on the field. Not injured on that blindside block, by the way. It was away from that. Players down at about the 26-yard line. And trainers were in there pretty quickly. He is sitting up and might have been pointing at his leg there for a moment. And a little bit of a delay here as they tend to the BC player.
Well, you know, in a play like that, there's a lot of bodies in a short amount of a little tiny space there as everyone's kind of coming through the pile. A lot of people are moving. Pretty easy way to twist something. You know, someone kind of lands on the side of your leg, something like that. So they're just getting them off the ground here, which is a good sign. You know, favoring that left leg. And so he's going to try to put no weight on that as he comes off the sideline. Teammates helping him off, and they'll check him out a little bit more as he gets to the bench there. So hopefully we'll see him check that out, hopefully recover, maybe see him in the second half. And as we are down to 2:09 in the quarter, Alberta's going to want to get this ball a little bit out of their end to create some space. They're starting on their own what looks to be 7-yard line or so. And Alberta definitely wants to move the ball here. Again, a two and out here likely results in another safety possibly. But if they can get the ball moving, they got 2 minutes to score.
It's Mateo Kopeck, by the way, getting helped off the field, not able to put anything on that left leg. So we'll hope for the best for him. And like you said here, Rob, important set of downs here for Team Alberta. Stuck inside their own 10 at the 6-yard line. Comstock. Out wide, might have a receiver open and just off the fingertips. There is a couple flags on the field, one inside the 5 and one just outside the 15, and it's going to be a holding on Team Alberta.
Yeah, I think both officials, both flags saw the same thing, a little bit of holding there. And again, good shot play, trying to get out of their own end. And again, the ball was a little bit outside. I believe the receiver, even if he would have caught it, was already a few steps out of bounds. So again, interesting decision here, because the holding call usually results in 10-yard penalty. And I see the officials on the, or the refs, or the coaches on the sideline saying we should have declined that penalty because it would have been second and 10. Now it's first and like 14. So they didn't get the full advantage of the holding call being a 10-yard penalty. But needless to say, it's first and about 14 for Team Alberta, right near their own goal line.
Ball was on the 6. So half the distance is going to be just to the 3-yard line. So maybe a chance here for Team Alberta to make up for the incompletion. Pass out wide, and okay, well, there you go. I guess that worked out for Team BC. You forced the stop, and you're 3 yards better off for it.
Yeah, and still second down, so they still have the opportunity. And a little personnel change here. So, again, we saw great coverage on the secondary in there, and again, lots of time. So, great protection for Alberta's offensive line or the quarterback, just sitting in the end zone waiting to throw the ball, but couldn't find a receiver open, and now they've brought, I see come on the field, number 4. Logan Rubble for BC is on the field playing defensive ends. We got a tough receiver now lined up, a defensive end ready to bring some heat off the edge.
At the top of the line there. He's going to get pressure on the quarterback. Alberta gets the throwaway just in time. And it was into double coverage there and just out of the reach of Terrell Hoffland. Alberta is going to have to punt it away here. Might look to take the safety again. I always wondered here, Rob, if you are going to take the safety, why even send out the punt team? Why not just go to shotgun and get your quarterback to take the knee? It's a lot easier of a snap.
Yeah, you definitely can. And again, you know, again, who's used to doing that? You know, often your offense is not used to doing that. The other thing that it does is if you do want to run something, if you do want to like give the illusion you're going to punt, they're forced to put a punt returner back. So you're actually taking one person out of the box. In the end, it could work either way. Usually your punt team does that job. They've practiced that, and sure enough, they take the safety. So, you know, interesting, because with the play calling of Alberta on offense there, with two passes being incomplete, the clock stops. And so, you know, they only actually ran, I think it was about 18 seconds in that entire series off the clock, giving BC's offense enough time to move the ball. And as we saw in this week's CFL games, you don't want to leave any time on the clock for a team to score. And, you know, referring to that Ottawa game, big comeback there and scoring a bunch of points under 3 minutes, you know, changed the script in that game, obviously. But again, BC being able to move the ball a little bit and does have the ability to go downfield and get yards in chunks, has now a minute 49 left to get some points starting on their own 35.
It's the third time BC has scored this game, but it's the third safety. So they're still down by 2, 8-6 here, and a chance to take the lead for BC with under 2 minutes left to play in the second quarter. Connolly, empty backfield, going wide, and just out of the reach of the receiver. He was looking in the direction of Dante Meyer.
Interesting there at the end of that play. Some contact as the ball arrived, which again, I don't think was pass interference, as the refs did not throw any flags. BC was hoping for a little bit, but interesting that the receiver was the one telling the bench, hey, take it easy, we don't need another penalty from the bench. If that's where the first one came from, he's like, I'll make a better play on the ball next time. So, you know, really, really working that. Yeah, that's the type of player you want to see. Keeps his head, really works hard. He's going to come back. We'll see if they take another shot here, because again, first shot happens, now they got to convert this second and 10.
Well, now if you throw another incompletion, now you've only ran about 15 seconds off the clock, and Alberta's going to get it back up by 2. So important second down here for Connolly in the offense. Connolly, another deep shot. And this one is nearly intercepted. It was in the fingers of Boston McCory. Maybe just as good, though. Forces the incompletion, and BC going to have to punt this one away.
Well, as you said, another 10 seconds off the clock, punting this ball away, another 5 or 6 off the clock. But, you know, BC had a couple really nice play calls, and they took shots downfield. Unfortunately, the ball was just not delivered in a timely fashion. Again, receiver was open when that ball was thrown, but he needs to learn to throw him into that open space, because he took so long to throw the ball, and it wasn't a great deep ball, Alberta had time to move over. So their secondary responded really quickly to the ball being thrown and was able to get the knockdown as opposed to what appeared to be a good opportunity on offense.
Punt away here, bouncing just outside the Alberta 50. Picked up by Hoffman, and not a ton on the return. Probably just a few extra yards of what they would have had on the interception.
Well, I like the aggression of both offenses taking shots downfield and throwing the ball, but what's the result? I mean, we got lots of time still on the clock, and Alberta, really the exchange there. So they were in their own end. They took the safety, so they gave up some points. They gained some field position, but got the ball back with, again, plenty of time for them to move into scoring range and get some points before the end of the half.
See if someone looks to the ground game sooner than later. At some point, there's still a minute 25 left. Canadian game, that's a ton of time. And sometimes you'll see a coach going to the ground on the first play just to make sure they take some time off. It will be a pass, flushed out of the pocket immediately as Comstock gets it away to Hoffman, and he's got big yardage. Hoffman down to the 30.
Wow, and great wheels down the sideline. Again, nice catch too. Wasn't the easiest. It was a little bit low. You can see as he rolls out here, he finds his receiver. DB's pretty close, but he turns on the jets and gets the edge. Now they're in great position to score.
27 yards. Not good at math. 28 yards on the play for Team Alberta. And there is a player taking a knee. And that is Hoffland for Team Alberta, who's down at about the 40. Didn't see if anything happened at the end of that play. This would be a big loss. He's been the spark in the Alberta offense so far. Kick returner as well.
Yeah, and it may just be a little bit of an exhaustion thing, a little tweak. He doesn't seem to be too injured. He's up and walking off, and so I'm sure we will see him back on the field shortly. But again, big play there, putting his offense in a great position to get some points here before the end of the half.
So late in the half, he will have to take a few plays off. Important plays here with 77 seconds left in the second quarter. Team Alberta looking to extend on their two-point lead. Haven't seen any field goal attempts yet, so not sure if they're within range or how many more yards they'll need to be within range. Comstock looking for the end zone. He's got a receiver open and just overthrows him.
Well, I really like what these teams are trying to do on offense and attack the secondary. I don't think the secondary on either of these teams can match up real well, so they're going to have to find ways to contain the passing game. Again, they've missed a couple deep balls, both teams here, and Alberta definitely is seeing the same thing I'm seeing up here, where attacking that secondary may be a way to get some momentum and some majors on the board here. So we'll see what they do here on second and 10, but I like the aggression that both offenses are showing here late in the half to attack the secondary and get the ball downfield.
I had to do about a triple take there, as I thought I seen number 10 open in the end zone. That's Josh Martell. He opened up the game at quarterback. Nearly scored a touchdown as a receiver. Comstock, quick swing pass out left to the running back, Siddle. Siddle trying to make a man miss, and a good tackle there for Team BC. Maxim Roberts allowing that play to only go for a couple yards.
Well, in decision time for Alberta, it looks like they're bringing out the field goal team or the field goal kicker. We'll see. Again, third and long. Not willing to take the risk here and seeing if they can get a few points off the foot of their kicker.
It's not like I haven't seen it before, but I don't think any coach that's sane wants to punt it from the 27-yard line.
Well, and in a tournament like this, in a game like this, you know, sometimes you'd just be tempted to go for it here and see if you can get the opportunity. I mean, with a minute 4 on the clock, a little bit of time. They used about less than half the time that was left when they got the ball. So now they've got a timeout by Alberta, either to get things organized or to think it over and maybe see if they can get a major here.
Would be about a 35-yarder here for Dawson Treen. That's deep at this level.
That is a long field goal, and that's why maybe that conversation is had, is this what we want to do? It doesn't seem like they're going to change personnel or change their minds on the call, so I'm sure we're seeing the field goal unit come back out. But yeah, good distance for a high school kicker to make a field goal here, so we'll see if he can convert on this one.
I always say to people, if you think a 35-yard field goal is easy, go out and try it. Yeah. And usually you'll see people put the ball down at the 10 and maybe just sneak it over the crossbar, like maybe. And then as soon as they're outside of 15, they're just done.
Yeah, no, it's tough. It's tough from anywhere, even just how to kick the ball. I mean, sometimes you get soccer players trying it with the leg strength but not the technique. And often you'll see actually teams look to their soccer team for a soccer player. And if you can adjust the technique just slightly for football, you've got the leg strength that can often play a big part in this. So we'll see if from 35 he can convert and get some more points for Alberta.
James Christian in the end zone, hoping for a miss. I believe that's Christian at least. Kick is up, has the distance, and it's good. Great kick for Dawson Shreen. Good from 35 and extends the Alberta lead 2-5.
Yeah, great job converting again. We've seemed to just flip-flop back and forth, but still time left on the clock. And so we've got 57 seconds left. And as we've said plenty of times in the last 5 minutes, that lots of time for the offense to move. But also, you also, again, as we've said, you don't want to go two and out 16 seconds and then punt out of your own end, because special teams has been a little sporadic on both sides, some good kicks, some not so good kicks. So we'll see what BC's approach to this last minute of the half is.
So once again, Team Alberta taking a safety in their own end. Field position goes back and forth, and once again, it works out for them. They've been able to build a 5-point lead off of safeties. It's been a bit of a weird game scoring-wise, 11-6. Still might be a score, Gami. Which means I've never seen this score before. So BC with just under a minute. I believe I see Team Saskatchewan on the far side of the field starting to walk in. They'll play shortly after this game for the gold medal against Team Alberta Blue. Pass to the right side. Good first down production here for Team BC, picking up about 8.
Yeah, because of the tackle inbounds, that clock's going to be rolling here once the ball is placed. So BC's going to want to operate really quickly. And you can see the coaches on the sideline telling them to get this going, get this going. We have time. We get a first down. We got some opportunities. So in and out of the huddle. So the clock is starting. So time is on the way. We'll see if BC can move.
Yards to go for Team BC. Pass to the right is behind the receiver, Liam Gagne.
So stops the clock, puts them in a situation, second really short, now third and really short. See if they keep their offense on the field. Looks like they are. Interesting decisions being made here late in the quarter. And out a little personnel change, and we'll see what they do here on third and one.
It's actually 66 yards to the end zone for BC, and this is a huge play as they bring in their heavy package. Boy, you don't get this here with the clock stopped. Alberta's going to get the ball back with just under 30 seconds to play. And in BC territory, they look to the handoff. They're going play action. Pressure on the quarterback. Passes up and it's caught.
Well, that is a very interesting decision. What looked to be an easy quarterback sneak first down, they decide to drop back from under center and just throw it up. Now, they may be throwing it up to one of their best athletes in Rubble, and he made a great play on the ball, secured the catch. Again, reliable receiver and apparently reliable defensive lineman, as we saw in the last series here. But again, BC calling the timeout to stop the clock on the completion. That was a tackle inbound, and so at a moment like this, when you're trying to go hurry up on offense, you're teaching your players to get out of bounds when they can. So you get as many yards if you're in the middle of the field. You get down when the tackle happens and get the ball ready to go. Move quickly. In this case, the clock has been stopped. We'll see if BC can move the ball.
Need about 20 more yards here in 24 seconds to get into the range where you even start to think about a field goal. Deep pass over the middle to Rubble, trying to fight his way back to the ball and couldn't quite get there. 17 seconds left on the clock.
Well, definitely some arm strength there. We're seeing that, but I still think if he can throw that a little bit earlier, he can hit him in stride. You have a great athlete, a big, tall receiver there. Again, an incomplete pass does stop the clock, so we got a little change in quarterback. We're getting a different quarterback in. We'll see what they decide to do on 2nd and 10, but again, with 17 seconds, they're going to need to get a couple chunk plays to maybe get themselves in field goal position or bust one.
Switching quarterbacks every play. Witzel was the one that completed that pass to Rebel a couple plays ago. Looking deep over the middle. It's a bit of a floater and trying to dive back for the ball. That one's off the ground before Semrau can come back and touch it. And did he take a penalty?
He did. He did indeed.
Play came out late.
He really felt like he had the interception. And from my perspective, again, didn't have the perfect one. We'll see here on the replay. It wasn't. But that could be a costly penalty.
You see ball up in the air, and I thought it hit the ground too. Yeah, clearly did. So, boy, Semrau, though, taking the penalty here, had a lot of words to say to the official after. It's a 10-yard call, and now BC has the ball at the 44. Maybe time for one more play here before you look to get it in field goal range.
Yeah, you'd probably need a mid-range pass around 15 yards or deeper to give themselves a chance. Being on the 44, they're going to need to get a few. I'm not sure what the leg strength of the BC kicker is. So, again, taking a shot. You've got some athletes. You got some decent matchups in the secondary. We've got three receivers to the right with only two DBs out there. They're going to be dropping into a zone.
Shot over the middle is complete. BC is going to get a lot more than a field goal. Chapman is into the end zone. Touchdown, BC!
Well, and there you have it. A little bit better field position after the undisciplined penalty, hitting them down the seam in between the two defenders and into the end zone. So BC grabbing some points and the momentum here as they tick down with only 4 seconds left on the clock in the half. BC takes advantage of the minute they had and get the touchdown.
BC going to go for the single and look to extend that lead to two. Just two. Boy, what a costly penalty, though. On that unsportsmanlike conduct, you're looking at, really, probably BC would have been forced to punt. And now they will convert on the extra point. 2-point lead for BC with 4 seconds left in the half.
Well, it's taken a while, but BC got their major, and again, that gives them the lead. So great job of BC, and really, I think going into the half, the coaches are going to have some conversations about points left on the board. We've seen the ball get moved both directions by these offenses, and again, just not finishing in a lot of touchdowns, as you mentioned. Safeties are great, not the types of points you want to get, but it's good when your defense can come up and make a stand. But again, it's also a sign of offenses not converting in the red zone. So maybe at the half, we'll have a little bit of chance to talk about some of those pieces that hopefully we'll see in the second half.
Probably going to see a pooch kick here from BC.
Well, they definitely have some athletes in the return game here for Alberta. So, again, not likely to kick it to a returner, but you never know. Again, you don't want to – you hopefully this play ends the half is what you're hoping for as the BC player.
They are going to squib it. Picked up by one of the men over the middle. And nothing there for James Drake. Not a bad guy to have on the return. And zeros on the clock. We'll bring it into the second quarter. Rob, an interesting quarter. 13-11 for BC off of three safeties, a touchdown, and an extra point. And Alberta able to score a field goal, a touchdown, an extra point, and a rouge. Gotta love the way the Canadian game is scored.
Well, it's not often in half of football you're going to see all those types of scores, but we have seen them all. We've seen every one, I think, in the Canadian game that's possible to score. So competitive half for sure of football. Offense is finding a way. We've seen some defensive battles over the course of this week in the Canada Cup, of course. And those are, you know, strong defensive performances. Offense is just trying to find their groove. I think in this game, the offenses have been willing to take shots, move the ball in chunk plays with big yards. And they've done a really good job of moving it, just haven't been able to score in the red zone. And that's definitely something I want to see a little bit more of in the second half. And we saw it late there as BC took the shot and scored from a distance out. But getting close to field goal range, they've been forced to take field goals and singles. And so I think the red zone production and really the poise to convert those instead of field goals and safeties and singles, get those into touchdowns and get majors from those.
So BC will take a 13-11 lead into the locker room. Slim margin here. BC will look to defend over the last 24 minutes of the game. Join us for what's promising to be a close and entertaining second half of football here from Emerald Hills. Welcome back to Emerald Hills here in Sherwood Park, Alberta, Canada, for the bronze medal game of the U18 Western Showcase. Team BC coming into the second half with just a slim 2-point lead, 13-11, off of a few safeties and a touchdown. We've seen every method of scoring besides a 2-point conversion. And Rob, we've seen some real interesting football in that first half. Team Alberta down 2. What do you think their adjustments are in the locker room, and what do you expect to see here in the second?
Well, I think the feeling maybe going into the half is a few undisciplined plays cost them a little bit of points on the board, especially that last touchdown. Again, touchdown could have scored from anywhere, but definitely not happy with those types of plays by the players or decisions by the players that cost them a little bit. And BC obviously took advantage late and went to the air. I really think both these teams are going to look to attack the secondary. I think that's a way they can move the ball and get some points on the board. I think red zone production is going to be a focus for both these teams. They've kind of been able to move the ball between the 30s, but just not being able to get it into the end zone consistently with all the opportunities. And as I mentioned before we took the break for the half, is teams like move the ball, and then you almost this frustration build, just can't get the major. So BC getting a little momentum there as they go into the half with the major and the lead now, and so they're going to come out, try to build on that and get some momentum here.
Story of the weekend has been the smoke sitting at a 5 here at Emerald Hills, so seemingly we're going to finish this game here unless there's somehow a drastic change, maybe a fire on the field in the second half here. I don't want to tempt anything. There's been some crazy weather here lately.
Well, I'd like to see both these offenses catch some fire and give us some fireworks out here. Not the kind that cause more smoke, but the kind that'll cause some excitement and energy in the stadium here. Of course, we got a doubleheader today here. Hopefully that will continue to be the case. It does appear, though, as we look across the field, it maybe not quite as smoky as it was at the beginning of the game. I think it's gotten a little bit better. So boys are excited, they're fired up, and we are ready for a second half of football.
Team Saskatchewan and Team Alberta Blue will kick off at 1:30 with a gold medal on the line, but bronze medal on the line here between Team Alberta White and Team BC. And you would expect that the way that first half was played, these two teams pretty evenly matched. Don't expect anyone to walk away with this one. If you're going to win it, you're going to have to earn it.
Well, I think so, and it may come down to, as we saw in the end of the first half, you mean possessions, back and forth, some two and outs. Alberta moved the ball, ended up getting some points, and BC responded with a minute left. So as we've seen in football around the country this week, no time is can be wasted in these games. It's going to come down to maybe the last possession of the game.
So Team Alberta White will take the opening kickoff. Bounces just outside their own 25, picked up. Might be a return here for Terrell Hoffland. Down the sideline, across the 50. He's behind everybody. Across the 10, he's going to score. Terrell Hoffland with a huge return. And what an opening to the second half for Team Alberta.
Well, and we wondered if he would get back on the field after that long run and the stint where he had to get taken off. And what a way to grab momentum back from BC with a special teams touchdown. And so again, we've seen BC have the edge in special teams with regards to punt and maybe some kickoff return. Well, that just flips the script. Alberta gets the touchdown with the huge kickoff return.
So Team Alberta already flipping the script. Take a 2-point deficit and turn it into a 4-point lead. Field goal kickers a little late. Dawson Treen on for the extra point. He's made from 35. Extra points just 12 yards here in the high school game. Treen kick is up and has more than enough leg as it's through the back of the end zone and good for the extra point. Team Alberta with a lead of 5.
Yeah, great execution on the convert again. None of those plays are a given, especially when it comes to high school players still developing those skills. But snap got right to where it needed to be. Holder got it down in a timely fashion and executed just perfectly. And that's what you want to see. And again, when you have likely 3 players from 3 different high school teams around the province trying to execute that, it sometimes does take work timing and practice. And so clearly there, it was executed to perfection, got the point, and now BC, let's see how they respond. Because not only did the points go the other way, but also the energy and momentum. We'll see. Now it's BC's opportunity to respond. And we talked about teams catching fire. Well, Alberta's special teams caught fire. We'll see what BC can do here on their return.
So BC looking to fire back with a return of their own. Treen to kick it away for Alberta. 14 seconds and 7 points for Alberta. Oh, BC fumbles it. Returner's not sure where the ball is. Groneveld able to pick it up. He's going to cross the 30, bounce it to the outside, and Groneveld nearly had something big on the return there. Ends up getting taken down at his own 38.
Well, and you can see as that kick comes down, he kind of fields it with his hands up in the air, and it kind of goes off his mask. Let's take a look here at the replay. Yeah, you see he bounces a little bit off his mask, and he loses sight of where it went and corrals it. But here's the crazy part. Sometimes where the timing gets off in a case like that, that's where there's gaps created in the cover team, and you almost saw him hit the hole. Great return nonetheless, almost out to his 40. We'll see if BC can move the ball.
Scored a touchdown on their last possession of the first half. Huge run here for BC. Xander Tabara getting right near that first down yardstick.
Well, and with athletic receivers like Rubble, they get them in the run game by blocking. And you can see on that play, Rubble coming across the field, picking up one of the box players, again, creating a seam. Good job, good opportunity for BC.
They'll run it right up the gut looking for that first down yardage. They're going to pick it up and maybe an extra couple of yards there as well as BC picks up their first down of the second half.
I definitely like the conservative call on second and one. They seem to have been making different calls in the first half and it hasn't played out in their favor. Don't mind those. Don't mind taking a shot like that, but I think just converting it, again, needing to build that momentum back after the big return touchdown by Alberta.
12 yards on the drive so far in two plays, all on the run for Team BC. We'll see if they stick to the ground. We're going to empty the backfield here. Quick hitter out to the left on the slant. And good pitch and catch there for 9 yards on first down.
Yeah, and you can see them. Different, little bit of a different look. Haven't seen a lot of empty backfield, but BC just emptying it out, getting 6 receivers out, not necessarily changing personnel. And so they leave their running backs in, and they just move to the receiver position, either to block off the edge or run different routes. But in that case, 3 on each side, really empty backfield, just looking to attack that secondary through the passing game.
1.5 yards to go on second down. And something happened on that snap. BC back on their own 35. There's flags everywhere on the field. And right now that's going to go down for a loss of, I don't even know, like 30 yards. And we'll see what the flag is for. It looked like the quarterback wasn't ready for the snap yet when the snap was made. Let's see here on the replay.
And maybe he called it on set and not really remembered once he got everybody. Because he had personnel running around, so a few receivers were moving around. And then he said set. And if the indication in the huddle was that the snap was to come up on set, that's obviously what happened there. It's still high, which was interesting. But clearly it looks like the penalty's against BC. But because of the loss on the play, they'll likely just decline this, and it'll now be second in 25, 24, 23 maybe, quite a long ways, or actually be third down, I guess. We'll see what this ends up being, but clearly a miscommunication that flipped the script here.
That ball is going to go way back, 10, 20, 30. It's a third down, and is that 38 yards? Now, it looked like Witzel was clapping on the replay there. It looked like he was looking at a receiver and clapping. He's kind of... And can that throw a center off when you do something like that? Because Witzel definitely wasn't ready for the snap. He wasn't even looking there.
No, he wasn't. And whether that's just miscommunication, missed snap count, clearly a huge mistake. And then the penalty on top of that. So what that means is the penalty likely added on to the loss of the play already. And now they're deep in their own end.
So on a 3rd and 38, BC's going to have to punt it away. And the punt's not going very far either. It's going to bounce back towards BC. And BC was in no yards territory that whole time. So, Boy, Alberta's going to get the ball here deep into BC territory after a flurry of mistakes by the team in orange.
So let's take a look at the replay and see where that kicker goes. I thought the kicker was going to be chasing this ball down. Again, sees it high in the air. That ball bounced around for a long time. Good opportunity to run up there, but couldn't quite get there. And so you can see Alberta, yeah, great field position. Huge mistake by BC after, you know, finding a little bit of movement, getting a first down, taking some negative yards, and almost no net yard gains on the kick.
So Alberta has the ball at the BC 28. Look into the end zone. They're looking for Page. He's got it. That's James Drake, rather, into the end zone. Touchdown, Team Alberta.
So great play call again. Mistake by BC on their side, and Alberta going right after the touchdown. And sure enough, perfectly delivered ball, exposing the secondary and scoring a touchdown right away after the short punt by BC.
Boy, 3 minutes into the second half, and Team Alberta, pending an extra point, is going to go up 14 points here. If Dawson Treen can put it through the uprights. Like you said, Rob, nothing a given in high school football. So important plays here always. As Alberta looks to extend the lead to 12. Kick is up and it is through from Treen. Rob, what happened in that Team Alberta locker room?
Well, I think we talked about leaving points on the board, a few undisciplined plays. Again, you can eliminate those, and we end up getting them on the other side this time. And again, some just grinding it out, again, staying with it. We did see production. We saw offensive production. We saw teams move the ball, but just lack of consistency in the red zone. And, of course, with the big special teams play, the energy gets a jolt. Again, the defense came out after the mishap on BC's offense, getting good field position, and Alberta just executed there to score that major. So energy's here in the stadium. Players are fired up, excited. BC is going to have to find a way to get back into this one.
So now, Team BC, they came into the half with a lead of 2. They're down by 12 just under 3 minutes later. And with their offense trotting back onto the field after this play, as long as they can keep possession, as the kick is fielded by Chapman inside his own 20. Chapman makes a couple miss, has some room on the left side. Matthew Chapman trying to turn the corner. He's going to take it back up over the middle. Chapman still on his feet across the 45 and finally brought down inside his own 50. Maybe a bit of a spark being brought on special teams here in an important drive for the team BC offense trotting onto the field.
Well, and this is where the offense need to capitalize on the great return and the energy from that return. This is a critical drive for them. They've got to move the ball and get some points. They can't afford another blunder like their last series. And again, starting off with a good return. Great patience, lead blockers, just waiting for that seam. Couldn't quite find the seam to take that to the house, but it definitely had the potential. So the kickoff return team can definitely build on that next time they see the field, if they see the field. But right now, the onus is on the offense to get some energy going and some yardage here.
Witzel, they'll fake the jet pass over the middle. Big yardage here for Team BC on the first play of their drive. And finally getting taken down is Matt Chapman again. Two big plays for Chapman as Team BC inside the Alberta 30.
Well, exactly what they needed is a big play, and now we're going to see if they can convert as they get close to the red zone here. Again, using motion in the backfield to hold the linebackers a little bit longer is opening up the seam routes, and they've done a great job a couple times. That's a similar play that they hit the touchdown on before the half, and now they're going to go back on offense here with a first and 10 from the 29 to see if they can get some points.
This time, BC gonna run it right up the middle. Good first down yardage again for Team BC on the run. Looks like a name we hadn't called yet. That's Josh Vacunet into the game. And that might be good for a first down. That's right at the marker. And it will be good for the first down, and BC makes a trip into the Alberta red zone.
So Alberta making a couple substitutions here, seeing that BC is on the move, really trying to make sure that they try to get a stand here. BC is poised to score.
Strong drive here from BC. With the momentum switching into Alberta's favor. But this run Looks like it's going nowhere. No room for Vankunet on the right side. This play is going to go for a loss.
Yeah, big stand by the front seven of Alberta, getting into the backfield in a hurry, and really right from the get-go, they got a significant push against the offensive line and were able to stymie the run there, forcing what will end up being a second and 12, although it got driven back. His forward momentum and forward progress was marked by the officials, so a loss of two. Second and 12, we'll see. I'm guessing they're probably going back to the air as they've found some success in the air here. We'll see what they do here to try to get some points.
That was Macklin Brown in on the stop. Important play here for BC. Pass goes out wide, tipped at the line of scrimmage, and that play will go nowhere for BC as it looks like their field goal unit is coming back on the field.
Well, BC got a great drive, needed to respond, and so they've called their field goal unit out. Like the call on second down, I think the quarterback committed to running, is throwing the underneath route, not recognizing and not reading. It was a timing route, so it came out early, but he had a rubble in the end zone on the corner route, left kind of uncovered. So we'll see if they come back to that play. The field goal is good. Confidence in your field goal unit, able to convert there. Getting points was important. Again, after giving up a couple majors quickly to Alberta off special teams and their offensive strike after the punt issue that they had, again, getting some points is critical. I know it's not a major, probably what BC wanted to come away with after a nice drive and some chunk plays there, but they did get some points, and now Alberta is going to be scrimmaging the ball from the 35 again. Battle going back and forth here. Points going both directions. We'll see if who comes out on top as Alberta's offense takes the field here.
That was good from 27 yards out for Andrew Lawson. Big kick. Cuts the deficit to 9 for BC. Empty backfield here for Josh Martell. Back into the game at quarterback. Flushed out to his right, evades the sack. Martell, still on his feet, makes another and nearly miss, and BC's able to take him down. Maxim Roberts with the sack.
Wow, great job by BC to respond there. Again, coverage is great downfield. Quarterback could not find a receiver open. He's just forced to scramble, run for his life, and after a couple of guys take their shots, they eventually get him down, putting him in a second and long situation. Almost an automatic passing down if you want to try to convert this. But of course, in these long passing downs, the defense is thinking the same thing. So that's where you look at maybe a draw slash screen to see if you can get some space. But I still think with the athletes Alberta has and some success through the air, they may be looking to go to the air and see if they can convert this second and 20, which is no easy task.
Loss of 10. Second and 20. They're going to look to the flats here. And that play going nowhere. Team BC gets the stop. And they're going to force Alberta to punt it away.
So going to the air, looking for the underneath with a little bit of running room. And again, he had the running room, but the pursuit of the defense was there on the spot to make the tackle after the reception. So great job of BC getting some points, getting a three and out. And as long as they can maintain, as you say, possession on the punt return, which is no guarantee in football, they'll have the ball in decent field position.
Well, these special team plays are so huge in a game like this. Low kick is going to go near the sidelines, but fielded by Chapman, who finds a seam up the sidelines and ends up taking it inside the 40. Good return for Chapman, his second straight. And he'll stay in the game at receiver. Actually, he's going to go to the sideline. Usually stays in the game at receiver. And but BC, great field position here. Already nearing field goal range, down by 9.
So from the original line of scrimmage, Alberta had it on the 35. They're getting it on the 39. So 4 yards gained. And BC is back on the field in great field position, as you mentioned. Great job by the returner to stay in bounds. Again, could have easily stepped out of bounds, but got an extra 5-6 yards after he tight walked the sideline there. So great opportunity for BC here.
They'll go play action. Quick pass over the middle. And boy, that was a little out of the reach of Gubel, but he got a hand on it. Otherwise, that one might have been getting picked.
Yeah, and I think he kind of thought there was contact coming, but, you know, he is a big, solid receiver. And so, you know, the DB did not look poised to lay a lick on him. Have we seen a couple free safeties come down on receivers? Wasn't really poised. I would have liked to see a little more effort maybe on Rubble. You know, I know it was a stretch and it would have been like an all-star catch, but he looks like an all-star player. And I think, you know, making that reception was possible. Let's see if they can convert this second and 10.
Important just to get some yards here. Maybe you go for it on third down, but Witzel gonna get sacked. Louisen was in the area. And it was Kingston Pritchard, I believe that's his second sack of the day, who ends up taking down the quarterback.
So personnel getting changed on both sides. I'm guessing we're looking at a punt for BC and a punt return for Alberta. Again, opportunities right here for BC to try to see if they can pin them deep. And Alberta, of course, working with a dangerous punt returner back there to see if they can get some field position with a great return.
Hoffman is back. He's returned a kick already for a touchdown. Going to be fielded inside the 20. This time, Hoffman met nearly right away, has him stumbling inside his own 20, and a much better special teams play there by BC, as the return's only going to go for a couple yards.
Well, and you can see on the replay, great punt, a little bit of hang time. The coverage team is getting downfield, and you see the first guy in. Doesn't get the tackle, but definitely gets him enough, stops his feet for his teammates to arrive and secure that. So good punt, good exchange, and great coverage there. Alberta's working from their own end. We'll see if their offense, which was just got had a three and out last series, and see if their offense can get on the move.
Ball at the Alberta 19-yard line. Opportunity here for BC's defense. A quick stop and you get the ball back, probably on the Alberta side of the field. Martel back in at quarterback. They're going to hand it off. Straight run up the middle. Met at the line of scrimmage and nothing there. Big play for the D-line of BC.
Well, same start as the last series. Alberta's out there. Started with the run. BC's front seven doing a great job. And so we'll see if the BC defense can stiffen once again, forcing a possible punt situation.
Feels like it's been a pretty short third quarter here with just over 2 minutes to play. Second down and about 8.5. Surprised they even picked up 1.5 yards on that first play. They're going to pitch it to a receiver. It's a trick play, a throw over the middle, and that one was closer to a BC player than anybody. Anderson Bicknell in the area. Some trickeration from the Alberta offense goes nowhere, and the punt team's out on the field.
Wow, and they had Riley Hutton deep on a corner route. If they would have had time to throw it, likely could have been a touchdown. But unfortunately for Alberta, and BC's defense stepped up into the backfield early to just eliminate any possibility of the reverse guy setting his feet and throwing the ball. So good opportunity squandered by Alberta. BC stepping up big on defense, shutting it down, and likely getting the ball back.
Earlier in the game, Alberta took a safety near that same yardage. This time a punt bouncing just outside the Alberta 40, out at the 43.
Yeah, maybe wishing after that short punt that they did take the safety on that one. Again, they've got a little bit of a lead, 25-16. Again, could have given up the two to take the field position, but BC once again back on the field on offense, ready to move. So Alberta's offense has struggled this half, other than the one touchdown off the very short field because of the punt by BC. BC's definitely produced more offensive yards, and they are back on the field looking for more.
Boy, Hutton was open though. They almost had an insane trick play touchdown from inside their own 20. Instead, BC with the ball. Throw to the left, cut on the slant, and a quick gain there for Groeneveld in the BC offense.
Yeah, we talked about Hutton, and again, had an opportunity to actually coach him a little bit. He was actually playing DB with the Golden Bears Select programs this winter, and so I found that very, very good athlete, can play both sides of the ball, understand space and movement. I'd like to see them get him involved in knowing his athleticism and his ability to contribute.
Second and 5 for BC. They're going deep. They're looking for Rubel. Goes up and draws the flag. Boy, Rob, sometimes you can't make the catch, but you fight hard enough and you might draw that 15-yard penalty.
Well, and you can see him going to the corner route, and that's actually the same play. He was wide open in the end zone where they came underneath. But again, when you teach those receivers, as we said, to fight back to the ball, he fought back. There was enough contact. And again, they let a couple things go in the first half. I think we all saw those, and the benches clearly saw them as well. But that one, enough contact with him fighting back for the ball. They just could not throw the flag there. And it's good to let these guys play a little bit with contact. But once it impacts it enough, they need to do something. So BC is on the move here.
That was Kendrick Price picking up the flag. They'll fake the handoff one way, and it'll go the other. And nothing there for Maddox Elson. His first touch of the day. Actually, it might have been Kieran Hamilton.
Well, a couple guys, Macklin coming in from the D-line spot, making the initial contact, and then the heavy pursuit by that front seven of Alberta, just wrapping it up with about three guys on the tackle.
BC is in field goal range right now. Wind would be a little bit in their face here, so would at least like to pick up some yardage here on second down. Quarterback draw, met at the line. And boy, you got to be careful here. As Team Alberta was fighting through the final whistle, BC wanted a penalty for a second. They're not going to get it. And a big sack, meanwhile, for Team Alberta forces what might be a long field goal attempt here. And I think this is the punt unit coming out. It'll be a 37-yarder from here, maybe just outside the range of BC's kicker, Andrew Lawson.
I think they just called field goal. I'm trying to listen in on the bench conversations. I know Alberta got their punt return team out there by what the coaches are saying, but not sure if we got field goal here. It does look like they're
out
lining
there
up. So, again, a long field goal, opting to look for points as opposed to field position. We'll see if it's got the leg. We got a 37-yard attempt here.
Little bit of wind in the face of Lawson. Snap is off, hold is down, kick is up, and it's going to be short. Bounces inside the five. Alberta touched it, but it's going to be a no yards. So BC on the last play of the third quarter, a chance to cut it down to a one possession deficit. But kick just a bit short. Like I said there, wind in the face, Rob. And BC, yeah, also with the no yards.
He was just inside that no yards. It wasn't a lot because, again, he had the returner kind of jumped and touched it before he actually maintained possession. And that was Hutton back there that we talked about. Great athlete getting the ball in his hands, and they got him out there on the return team. Unfortunately, he couldn't field it in time to make a play. But so, yeah, they're going to move it out there because of that penalty. So instead of being really tight inside the 5-yard line, they're going to be out just past the 15. So better field position for Alberta. But Alberta has got to get something going here on offense. They have been playing this whole half in their own end other than the very beginning there. And BC's defense has stepped up big in this half.
Quarter can't end on a flag. So one last play here before we go to the fourth quarter. Deep passing play for Team Alberta. It's juggled! And oh! I didn't think that hit the ground, but they're going to say it did. Well-defended play for Team BC.
Wow. Almost picked off, and again, he turned his head at the perfect time. You'll see here on the replay, he's in tight coverage, and again, a tight window, but he turns his head, lands, and it bobbles, and then hits the ground on one bounce before BC gets it. But great defense and good job getting the head around. Often that's the hardest thing for DBs, is to get their head around at the right time. So they're either making a play early on the receiver in a situation like that, but again, turned his head, located the ball, just couldn't squeeze it. Again, turnover would have been huge for BC, but Alberta now facing a 2nd and 10 in their own end, and they've seen a fair bit of that this half. And again, going into the fourth quarter, their offense has got to get the move on to maintain this lead. BC really hasn't taken advantage of the good field position they had in the entire third quarter.
By the way, in the first half, we've seen Mateo Kopech go down hurt, and he's got that left knee wrapped up on the sideline right now, and he's on crutches, so unfortunately won't be able to return. We'll hope for the best for him. Team Alberta on 2nd and 10, they're going to run it up the middle, and BC comes up with a stop, And they're going to get the ball back in good field range once again, as long as they can keep possession.
So again, once again, that BC defense really stepping it up. The return team's coming out. Again, we'll see what Alberta decides to do with a 25-16 lead. They could opt for the field position and safety. BC seems to be able to move the ball in a chunk play or two, but just can't turn it into touchdowns today.
We have seen a snap over the head of Josh Martel. So anything can happen on these special teams plays, as Alberta's going to call a timeout and make sure they're organized on the punt.
Looks like the refs are definitely discussing what the decision is here. I think to, you know, whether it's a safety or a punt. Again, I saw the head man on the bench of Alberta looking up for the score, the time. What does field position look like for them? And we'll see what they come out and decide to do. Again, lots in the conversation right now on the Alberta sideline. Obviously, BC just hoping for a punt here and getting possession. But again, got to score with that. And Alberta making a decision. Now it comes to strategy. And so often as a coach, as you get into the fourth quarter, you start thinking about, okay, how many points are we up by? What do we do at different points in the game? And what is that strategy? So we'll see what Alberta discussed and what they came out with the decision on. And we'll see what happens here.
Well, 11 minutes left in the fourth quarter. Up by 9. If Alberta did elect to take the safety, that would make it a 7-point game. And then any play from BC could pretty much tie it at that point. I would expect that Martel is going to be punting away here. But we've seen Alberta do both so far today. Big special teams play, though. Martel, he is going to punt it away, and it's not a good one. And, well, you'll see the official whistle it down here. Rob, sometimes that punt just gets a little high, a little short, and that's just a player safety thing there as to why they whistle it. However, a bit of a bad bounce there for Team BC, because that ball was bouncing straight back towards Alberta.
Yeah, and again, what could happen there is because of the, as you mentioned, safety of players. As a kicker, you get on your horse. We talked about that. I just haven't seen the kickers get aggressive in this game. The kickers are all athletes, but BC in optimal field position here after the really short kick after the defense made a big stand.
BC on the 33-yard line. Feels like they need some points here sooner than later with under 11 minutes left. Lots of time. Run up the middle. Making a man miss. Big run here for Team BC. Another juke. They're trying to find the outside. What a run for Matt Chapman. Brings it inside the 10 and a flag at the end of the play as well.
Yeah, we'll see what the flag is. And we'll maybe to watch the replay. It may have been a face mask on the offense. Let's take a quick look here.
Either way, look at the moves from Chapman. He's been BC's biggest playmaker here.
You can see right there, there's a little bit of face mask, a little bit of horse collar too. So I think they got him on the horse collar because he didn't grasp the mask again with the stiff arm. It was legal, but the horse collar was not, and that's what brings him down to the one. So again, BC absolutely must get the major here. And I don't think they bring some heavy bodies in. We're going to see if they can just push this one in.
Connolly, in at quarterback. Looking to sneak it to the left. And he stopped just short. So they're going to put the ball down at the one. By the way, the ball was at the one. It's an unnecessary roughness penalty. So they put it down on the one instead of taking it half the distance. Injured player here for Team Alberta. And couldn't quite catch the number. So we'll take the second here.
Malcolm Rodericks out of Calgary. Father Lacombe High School. Number 95 down in the pile there again. A lot of bodies in that space. Again, Alberta was able to get a stiff stand there on the one-yard line. They've got two more cracks at it. And, you know, I hate to reference the Elks debacle on their 1 yard. They had first and goal on the one and couldn't get it in three times. It impacted the outcome of the game. And BC is poised here to get a major, and they've got to get this push in. We'll see. Coach is talking to their quarterback down here on the sideline in front of us, talking about possible a third down play. But leaving no doubt, getting it in on second down is what BC wants here, and this will draw this game much closer and make for a very exciting fourth quarter. It's already been an exciting half. Lots of scoring, lots of ball movement, some turnovers, and great special teams plays and others, but we'll see what they do here. Big, heavy backfield. They are lined up in the shotgun, though. We'll see what happens on second down.
See if Connolly sneaks under center. But as of now, lined up in the shotgun. Sometimes you'll see a quarterback line up in the shotgun and then run under center, just trying to keep the defense guessing a little bit. But looks like he'll take the snap from the 5-yard line. They're going to go to the air. Connolly to the right side, out of the reach of the receiver. Boy, interesting play call. 1 yard away, going to the air. And now it looks like Chase Witzel's going to come in and take the third down snap at quarterback.
No, Rubble not happy about that. Again, he felt like they were all over his backside, and there was definitely some contact, but as the ball arrives, you're allowed to make contact. And so I think they're bringing in some heavies here now, and we'll see if they can just drive this in.
Big play. 7 points on the line. 6 to start.
Two tight ends lined up and tight, tight splits by the offensive line.
Witzel, he's going to drop back to pass. Pressured, looks to the air, to Rubel. It was caught by somebody. Touchdown! What a catch for Logan Rubel! His best of the game in BC has cut the lead to 3.
Well, Rubble's the guy who lined up in the tight end position. And he just released, but released into double coverage. They were on him. You can see him coming off the left side, swimming out. DBs go out. Again, in double coverage, going up. Ball's being battled for, kind of on his helmet. Comes down with it, but what a huge play. And absolutely critical. Interesting play call, and it wouldn't have been the one I made, but great play call. Looks like they're actually lining up for what we haven't seen today, is a 2-point conversion.
You ever seen a Hail Mary from the 1-yard line before? That's just about what it looked like there, and Rubble comes down with it. Connolly in at quarterback for the 2-point conversion. Flushed out to the right, now looking to take it up the middle. He fumbled it. Ball recovered out of the end zone anyways, it looks like, so Alberta going to get the stop. Interesting decision to go for the 2-point conversion there. You can kick the single, get to 23, and then a field goal would give you the lead at that point. Whereas, I mean,
oh, to be in the minds of these coaches, yeah. Today, again, some interesting decisions, different strategy being used, but maybe thinking, you know, if you can get the 2, then you're only a single point away. You can get a punt single. But yeah, you know, it remains at 3. Still a field goal would tie it for BC, but I have to say, you know, the offense of Alberta has not found a way to move the ball, and BC is rolling both on special teams and on offense. And so we'll see how this one plays out over the last 9:47 left here in the fourth quarter.
Well, in the first 3 minutes of this second half, Alberta scored 14 points. Since then, nothing in what makes up to be about a quarter of action. Drake looking to take it to the outside, throws a stiff arm, and BC with a good tackle. Going to take down Drake just outside his own 30. And we got a 3-point game with 9.5 minutes left.
Well, I don't care who you are in this stadium. You know that this BC defense somehow in the second half has found the number of Alberta. And they have got to break that trend if Alberta wants to maintain this lead. They've played a little bit of field position, but Alberta has been stuck in their own end this entire half. BC finally getting the major on that last drive. We'll see what Alberta comes with here to attack this BC defense that has proven to be a challenge here in the half.
Quick hitter to the right side. Bit of a screen play here. Siddle over the middle. Ends up picking up 9 yards on first down.
Well, that's what you do with an aggressive defense that's fired up, as you run a screen play, a little misdirection to one side, coming back to the screen and getting great first down production.
Calls for a trainer here, as someone on Team Alberta's down.
I think is that Matthew Siddle, the actual ball carrier? I think a fullback maybe on that screen play. Did look like he took a couple awkward shots in the pile as he continued to fight for the yards. And so, although he came up a yard and a half short of the first down, they got second and one, and he is going to take his time here. They're going to take a quick look at what's going on.
Under 9 minutes left to play. Team Alberta Blue and Team Saskatchewan. You can see them warming up on one of the soccer fields on the far side. Team Saskatchewan on the right side there. You can see on the wide shot climbing a hill as they're headed out to warm up as well. They got the helmets on, ready to play for a gold medal.
on Saskatchewan has proven to be a huge challenge in the Canada Cup in this tournament as well, being this team in the Western Challenge, won by a large margin in their first game, and preparing for to face a strong Alberta team that also won their first game by a large margin. And then, of course, we unfortunately did not get to see the medal round for the Canada Cup, which, again, decision was made for player safety, and ultimately that is the best decision. Unfortunately for the players, they don't get to finish that one out. But this Saskatchewan team will have the opportunity, along with Alberta, to play for gold in our next matchup. But back to this one, because this is far from over. A tight match, as we anticipated, with both teams looking to take a bigger lead in this, and Alberta's opportunity is here with a second and short.
Just over a yard to go. Alberta's going to sneak it. They're going to get a lot more than just a yard and a half here. Big pickup for James Comstock in the Alberta offense, who are able to move the chains.
I think that's the first down in a long time by this Alberta offense, so positive things to build on. Here we go. Let's see if they can keep it going.
By the way, talking about the air, we're at a 7, so it is climbing. Due to get to a 9 later today. We hope that number stays a little lower. Football's not a guarantee. You know, you wake up on the weekend, and here in Edmonton, if it's a lightning storm or, you know, smoke in the air, you know there must be football on the weekend. That always seems to be the way it is. Comstock fakes the handoff, flushed out left. He's going to pull it and run it himself. Comstock picks up about 5 yards on the play, maybe just 4. Decent pickup on first down.
Yeah, great play action in the backfield. You can see him give the hand there to the running back, but again, BC was not fooled, and they got the edge, but again, a lot of pursuit, just limiting the gain. Again, Alberta's going to need to find a way to keep this drive going.
Big play. Been a lot of big plays in this game.
Yeah, a good one. It seems like they've gone a little more conservative in their play calling here as the last few minutes here, but Alberta's looking to keep this drive going.
Comstock with 2 backs behind him. They will hand it off, trying to take it up the gut, turned around, and absolutely nothing for Jacob Hertz as Team BC comes up with a huge stop.
So exactly what BC needed is to get one more stop here. And again, the ball's back in the hands of BC after this punt. Again, looking for a punt return and then another opportunity. But again, the energy and the momentum I still think is in favor of BC. The defense once again coming up with a stop after the one first down that Alberta got. Again, forced to a punting situation here.
There's been some struggles on the punting unit for Team Alberta. Last one only went for a net gain of about 15 yards. This one, a better one off the foot of Josh Martel. Going to bounce just inside the 40, but this one's returnable as well. So once again, just a net difference of about 10 yards here as BC is going to get the ball at their own 50.
Well, and great heads-up play by Martel to field that, because again, he was not the returner on the play. He was one of the blockers, but he realized the ball was off to his side. Nobody was around. Quick thinking by picking that up and just getting the yards he could, and they get there on their own 50. Great field position because of that heads-up play by the special teams player, Martel.
So Team BC down by 3, under 7 minutes left. Tons of time for really anything to happen in this one. Connolly in at quarterback. Hand off, run up the middle. Another big gain for Chapman. Chapman, gain of 13. Chapman, you know, we've talked about Logan Rubble, but it's been Chapman kind of as the setup man, able to get Rubble into the spot to make those catches.
Well, they really have, and they've done a good job of using one to open up the other, and in that case, Rubble's in there blocking and getting some bodies in there, and having him in is like a fullback, and then Chapman just kind of gashing them when the seams are there, and so they've done a good job of using the talent they have on this BC team to attack them in different ways.
Chapman to the left of the quarterback, Rubble in the slot. Quick look out to the right, screen play. BC's gonna pick up some more yards here. This time it's Liam Gagne. 6-yard gain on first down.
We'll continue to find different guys to make plays. where BC's really found a way to get the balls in the hands of different playmakers. And I love that approach in these tournament-style, all-star type of games. It's just get the ball to the playmakers. Get the ball to the playmakers early and let them use their athleticism. In that case, great 7-yard pickup on the wide receiver screen.
Time ticking away. Not sure who that's in favor of right now with BC moving the ball down the field. Connolly looking to the right side. Caught. Chapman trying to make a man miss. He's got the first down and falls forward for a few more. Another first down for Team BC.
Great hands catch on that conversion of second down, giving them a new set of downs here. And as they creep closer to the goal line, looking for that go-ahead touchdown.
Another run for Chapman. Bit of a delay through the middle. Found a hole to get about half the yards he needed. And now the clock under 5 minutes left. BC keeping the clock ticking.
Well, and there's no rush for BC, and to take more time off the clock, poised to possibly take the lead or at least tie it with a field goal here, you know, using that clock up with a balanced approach is really wise by the BC play callers. And again, we'll see, they obviously need to continue the drive and need to try to get that major, but again, being clock aware at this point in time in the game is important.
Connolly, that pass is tipped. And another big play by the Alberta D-line that looked like it might have been Kingston Pritchard once again. Now BC might be in field goal range here. It would be about a 32 or 33-yarder, wind at their backs, and they will trot out the kicking unit.
We've seen that a couple of times. Alberta's defensive line are getting their hands up, and what you teach your D-line in situations where you see the ball come up in the quarterback's hands ready to throw it, if you're not going to get to him, get your hands up, and they've done that a few times, almost one leading to an interception, but again, falling to the turf in both cases, but they did a great job defending that, forcing the field goal attempt by BC.
Andrew Lawson, there's a slight breeze at his back. This one from 33. Alberta's all over it! Huge block! And the Alberta Special Teams unit forces the miss.
I think it was Rian Tuesday who got in there, and you can see he's coming off the edge. He actually doesn't even lay out for it because he's in so quickly, and they kick it right into his legs. And so, again, great speed off the edge to keep BC off the board and maintain the three-point lead.
And this isn't good. Down by a field goal. And that's the BC kicker, Andrew Lawson, down on the field, so a little bit of salt in the wound for BC here.
One for him, I think it was that kicking leg, because as he comes in, he kind of kicks it right into the lower body. Because it was blocked, his leg and his follow-through, there's nowhere for him to follow through and probably end up following through leg right into the legs or the lower body of the guy who blocked it. And so again, tough contact on the kicker, and you know, with a close game like this, you don't want to be down your kicker. So we'll see if he can walk this one off, because he may be called upon again later in this game.
Boy, even if he is able to come back, though, you wonder if that kicking leg is going to be 100% at this point. So we'll hope for Lawson to feel better. Not his fault that one was blocked. There was about three guys right in front of him and nowhere for that ball to go. That was just a wall.
Yeah, the snap and the timing on that was good. It was just speed off the edge, just beat them all to it.
Team Alberta, with under 4 minutes left, they're gonna go deep. And it's caught! James Drake once again, another huge play for Drake. And Team Alberta is gonna flip the field ball to BC 34.
So Alberta getting a big chunk play early, great play by the receiver. Now what they need to think about is how can they generate a drive So this clock just ticks away because they could run most of this time off the clock and not give BC that opportunity, because they have had opportunities. They've moved the ball, obviously couldn't convert on the last one after the special teams block by Alberta, and now Alberta's in a great field position here to run some time off this clock and add some points to this total.
46 yard play to Drake. Now they'll look for Hofflin off the sweep, trying to find the corner. Hofflin makes a couple guys miss and gets taken out inside the BC 25. He might have first down yardage here. It's going to be close.
Yeah, that was a great run, great choice. Again, it takes time off the clock. They're going to get this clock rolling here. Again, they did get first down yardage, so again, more time is going to be coming off the clock for BC here. That's going to be their biggest enemy right now, and this BC defense that has played outstanding this entire half has got to find a way to either get a turnover or a stop right away to give their offense at least one more opportunity to take the lead here.
Boy, BC needs a stop and they need a quick. Clock is stopped at 3 minutes.
Benches have been given their 3 minute warning. Okay, refs getting ready to get this thing going here for the last 3 minutes of this battle that's been tight all morning.
Comstock in the quarterback. Hurts to his left, Hofflin to his right. Hofflin's gonna get it again. Looking for the corner on the left side, running the wrong way, but now he finds the corner, able to get back to the line of scrimmage, and ends up being an impressive gain of one.
So again, running, going back to that sweep, trying to get to the edge here. You can see he's going out wide, stretches this one out. Great pursuit by the BC. They couldn't wrap it up for the loss. That would have been huge. That could have maybe pushed them outside of field goal range if they're not able to continue this drive. But in any case, great job of getting what he can on that run.
Goes for a gain of one. Ball of the BC 22. They need to stop. Comstock, four receivers to the right. He's going to look right now, a quick look left. He's looking for Drake, and that ball thrown well out of bounds. Not much open there for Drake.
No, tight coverage and really the ball way out of bounds. Bigger receiver out there on the slightly smaller DB, and you want to take advantage of that, but again, just not the right location on the ball, too much on it, and he threw it 5 yards out of bounds. So it looks like Alberta is calling for their field goal unit to come out to see if they can extend this 3-point lead to 6. Of course, BC getting a return man back there. A missed field goal here could result in a hefty return. So again, a lot at stake still here. Still a one-score game either way. And BC will have an opportunity. We'll see what happens here if that lead can be pushed to 6 by the Alberta Special Teams field goal unit.
Comstock to hold. Treen from 29 with a slight breeze in his face. Hold is down. Treen, ball is up. It's going to be close. And it misses wide. And now it's returnable. BC going to get it outside their own 15 and brought out just at their own 20. That brings up an interesting discussion point there. You take the single, you might get better field position, but now you're down by 4 and you can't get the field goal to tie.
Well, you do get a little bit better field position, but it's not a lot, because in this level of football, on a missed field goal, if you return it out past your goal line, you automatically get it at the 20-yard line. And so, again, usually your conversation is, if it's a missed field goal, get it out of the end zone because you're out to your 20. There's no risk of getting caught inside your 10 or something puts you in a vulnerable situation. Yes, there's a little bit of a difference, but keeping it within a field goal, I think, is important for BC at this stage.
BC, they still need about 50-plus yards here just to get it within field goal range. And they're looking for their best receiver. Logan Rubel, ball was just a bit out of his reach.
I love the idea, I love the call, but the quarterback has got to give him a chance. He has made play after play today. Great athlete, bigger receiver, clearly has a size advantage. But now we've seen both quarterbacks here late in this game just to overthrow their bigger, taller receivers. They got to give them a chance. And what you tell your quarterbacks is give them a little bit more air on the ball, a little bit more of a jump ball. That's turned down the favors of the receivers more often than not today.
Connolly gets the throwaway, but it's out of bounds. Third and 10. A minute 50 left on the clock. And is BC going to go for it?
I don't see a personnel change, and this is it. This is for all of us. If you give up the ball here without converting this third and 10, you know, Alberta can run almost, well, could run the rest of the clock off and almost automatically is going to get some points here. Again, we'll see what they do. This critical, critical third and 10 here late in the fourth quarter.
BC needs 10 to stay alive. Connolly to the air, looking for Rubel. He's got it at the 50.
Well, and going back to the money maker, making plays downfield, a little bit slow to get up. Took a little bit of a shot. Looks like he's taking his helmet off. So that is going to hurt BC. They have other weapons, but he is such a key piece and making a key play on that third and 10 down at their 50. So again, 60 yards away for this BC offense. They're going to have to find other playmakers if they want to take care of this and close this gap. Right now it's 25-22, a three-point Alberta lead. The star on offense for Alberta is getting taken care of by his trainer. So he will not be available, at least for a few plays here. We'll see what happens here with BC's offense finding a way to get it done here late in the fourth quarter at Emerald Hills in Sherwood Park, Alberta.
Well, Rubel down, like you said, Rob, that's going to be a big hit for this BC offense. He's been their best player. And if he's out of the game, at least he's out a hero. If he doesn't make that catch, there is no game. And he took a shot, walks off under his own power.
Well, I think it may have been contact with the head. He went up hard, and I think when he came down, maybe head like hit the turf. So we'll see if he steps back to the bench out of the training tent in a little bit. But BC's offense is on the move.
BC still needs about 35 yards to find field goal range. Another big play here, this one to Gagne. Gagne inside the 45. And another 17 yards for Team BC. And another first down as they keep the yardsticks moving.
Well, and you can see they come back to that underneath route again, just giving it some time, running the slant under the two verticals. And again, great hands catch, getting up field, getting a first down. BC continues to move the ball down the field, looking for at least 3 points to tie this one up, maybe a major to take the lead.
Ball on the 43, lots of time left, minute 20. Connolly looks to the left, gonna find Chapman. He's had some big plays in the second half, tries to make a man miss. And good team tackling there from Team Alberta, but a good first down gain regardless as Chapman picks up 8.
So great outstanding play here by Chapman, as you mentioned, to the flats, away he goes off to the side. Now with the one little thing Chapman's got to be aware of is the clock. Again, not angling to the sideline, opting to go upfield. That clock has now started ticking down at 107 and counting. BC is going to be facing the clock here a little bit. They have got to get some chunk plays and stop that clock.
Second down, obviously three down territory here, but they need 3. Connolly, quick look to the left. Has a receiver open, makes a man miss, makes another man miss. What a run! Groeneveld inside the 5, tripped up, flags everywhere, and he's marked just short.
Wow, we just saw a slide tackle attempt by
Alberta. Oh, hold on, they're calling it a touchdown.
It is a touchdown. The flag came because of the slide tackle attempt, so it would be a kicking motion, which you are not allowed to do. I think that was a D lineman, so hats off to the D lineman. He pursued hard, chasing the guy. Unfortunately, the slide tackle was not an option, so that will impact likely the kickoff position, I believe. So we'll see if that ends up rolling over to the kickoff. Yeah, we got that's the call, and so the touchdown is good. So BC has taken the lead late on the great pass and run play, and we'll see how this kickoff gets impacted, and can Alberta find a way with 40 seconds left in this game to get the ball down the field.
Huge touchdown. Well, Rubel goes down and Groeneveld stepped up Gagne with a big play in there as well. And now the extra point for Team BC. Remember, Andrew Lawson went down on the last field goal attempt, holding his right leg. He's back on the field now. And this is the big extra point to make it a four-point game. And there's some confusion on the Team BC sidelines. We'll see what's coming up on the kickoff. And Alberta jumped way offside. And unfortunately for Lawson, he takes another shot as a result. That was one of the more obvious calls for him.
Yeah, well, when he puts his hand on his hands on his helmet before the ball is even snapped, he knows, and it's a true tell sign for the officials who are all over that one. Again, doesn't make it a whole lot different. Again, you're moving in a little bit, or maybe taking that on the kickoff, as I would take the yards there on the kickoff. But the challenge here is you still have to shore up your protection. And clearly, protection was not shored up on their last field goal attempt. And on that one, I mean, again, offside, but nobody looked to be blocking him. So let's see if BC can shore up that edge, convert this, and turn it into a four-point lead from the current three-point lead they have.
It'll be interesting to see where BC is going to kick off from after a couple of penalties. Could play big into the field position game. Lawson lining up the extra point. Better protection on this one, and Lawson puts it right through. Four-point lead for BC.
So you can hear the coaches down here on the sideline for BC. Defensive coaches talking strategy late in this game. Again, Alberta has the opportunity here to score some points, but they're talking to the defense about keeping the offensive players in bounds. The reason you want to keep them in bounds once the offense is out here rolling is that keeps the clock rolling unless a timeout is used. So again, game strategy and a tight match here between BC and Alberta White. Coming down to the last 40 seconds, Alberta is under the gun to get a great return here, and hopefully the offense has the opportunity to move the ball. But BC has dominated the second half on defense. Alberta's going to need to find a way to break that.
Well, I will say this. There is a dangerous man wearing number 13 back on the Alberta 6-yard line. He opened up the second half with a kick return touchdown. And we'll see if they even give him a chance here after the penalty. BC kicking off from their own 50. And they're going to squib it. Alberta can't quite come up with a clean kick return. Gets to Hoffman, but the play was already dead. And Alberta not able to get a kick return here. 34 seconds left, and they got a lot of movement.
Well, we didn't see BC kick really deep. And whether it's just leg strength of the kicker, but again, their two most dynamic returners are really deep. Maybe switching one of those up for the next row of guys. So even if they do kick it short like they did there, you got sure hands, and then off to the races you can go with another returner back there. But BC is out on defense. Alberta on offense on their 27-yard line looking for a touchdown to win this one with less than 40 seconds left.
83 yards needed in 34 seconds. James Drake has been their big play guy so far. He's on the near sideline. BC sagging off. They look towards Drake, now looking the other way. Comstock rolling out to the left. He's going to run it now. He's going to throw it. And he actually had Hoffland open. I was wondering if he might have been past the line of scrimmage as well. That's a 9-second play that took off the clock, and nothing for Team Alberta.
Yeah, that is not what you want to do. You want to take the quick shots, quick passes early. Again, running around just buys time. Good job of taking off and finding some time and getting it deep. He just missed his receiver, who, like you said, was wide open, but it was just a miss. And again, throwing on the run is not easy. Again, you try that as well. It's not easy to do. Throw it, run to your left. Again, missed him. But they do have time, but they got to make some yards on this down.
83 yards still to go. You'd imagine Alberta at this point just wants to get it into Hail Mary range for their last play. Comstock looking left. He's pressured. Flushed out. Ball's out. Alberta falls on it, but a huge loss.
So as we've seen the dominance of this BC defense in the second half, it continues here on what could be the game-sealing drive for this defense. Alberta's offense now faces a third and 25, 26 yards. It's a long, long ways for them to go here. They have got to convert this third down, or this one will be in the books.
Well, we've seen a third and 24 yesterday in a Hail Mary go for a touchdown. It was a lot closer than their own 14-yard line. So anything can happen in Canadian football, but the clock is running, and you might need to see some hook and ladders here.
I think I would be looking at something like that, like a quick pass to open space. If they can outman them, they've got three receivers to the field side, and there's two DBs deep and one kind of governing the inside guy. I would throw it quick to a guy, try to get blockers out in front. But again, the flags come, got time count. So what was a third and 20 plus is now even going to be more. I think, again, with the soft defenders, you're either looking for a pass interference call or you're looking for a quick pass with maybe four. I would try to bring quads over to the field side because BC is going to be in defense. We've got a timeout by BC. They want to talk this through, make sure everyone's in the right position again. Highly unlikely Alberta's going to be able to convert, but you never know. And again, lots of space out on the field. So if you can outman them with a quad set to the back, to the field side, there is a lot of space. And again, they won't be tight in coverage. So if you can get a running back or a returner type of athlete in behind a couple blockers, I think you'd look at a play like that to see if you can get some open running room. Because again, we've seen open running room get created and exposed in this game. We'll see if Alberta has one more play left to keep their hopes alive.
This would be one of the, you know, you always say crazier things have happened. But last play of the game here for Team Alberta, for Team Alberta. And boy, if they can create this, it would be an absolute viral moment.
Get your cameras on. The cameras are live here from Emerald Hills. Again, phones in the stands are playing. This could be a moment.
BC's got to get out there.
BC, they do. The defense is back. So they're going to be soft. But again, you don't want to drop everybody deep because there's a lot of running room. It turns out to be like a big special team play if everyone's spread out through the course of the field. So they're going to be, look like they got 3D linemen to rush three guys, some linebackers and soft coverage guys. We'll see what Alberta has in their last hope.
104 yards to go. Last play of the game. Pass out to the right is caught, and here comes the hooks and the ladders. Hoffland has nobody behind him. BC, Hoffland throws it back again. Ball still alive. Alberta tackled at the two, and it's over. Gatorade showers on the BC sideline, and they've won the bronze medal.
Well, and what a huge win. This defense was absolutely amazing in this second half. Just stopping Alberta from getting anything going, taking losses. Special teams were back and forth on both sides of the ball here. But in the end, that BC defense who won this game in the second half was just stymieing the Alberta offense. And of course, BC's offense found a way to move the ball in critical moments in the fourth quarter to take the lead with the major, and the defense closing it out with what was hopeful for Alberta to be a scramble play, just didn't materialize, and BC finished this off with the defense on the field in classic form.
For Team BC, Rob, you give up two touchdowns in the first 3 minutes to open up the half. After that, pretty much nothing.
Well, and that speaks to the mental fortitude of this BC team. You know, they got a little excitement in the first half by scoring late, taking the lead. Like you said, giving up points early just to be able to recover from that was outstanding for BC. And again, the defense bought enough time, gave enough opportunities for the offense to get some scores late in the game here and finish this one out. Great job of overcoming the challenge of those touchdowns and then coming away with a victory.
So there will be a post-game presentation. Most valuable players, and then the bronze medals for BC. Coming up in, well, not long at all, about 26 minutes from now, we'll see kickoff between Team Alberta Blue and Team Saskatchewan with a gold medal on the line. We've seen some pretty good games from some individuals on either side today. Anyone you're looking at in these post-game player awards here? I mean, obviously, you got to look towards Rubel.
Yeah, I think you're going to have a hard time picking anybody else but him, you know, with the plays he made. You know, again, there are some, I mean, there's outstanding players, like you said, on both sides of the ball here. But, you know, making that play third and long, must convert for BC to even have a chance to win. You know, goes out, puts his body on the line on a high ball, ends up coming down, missing the end of that drive, but definitely doing well to keep that drive alive.
And then between the Rubel plays, it seemed to be Matthew Chapman for Team BC, a huge contributor as well. The teams will line up at their own 45. Game went a little long, so you can hear the PA guys saying they would like to expedite this a little bit as the next game is due to start here in not a lot of time at all. What a great game we had here from Emerald Hills to open up this championship Sunday at the U18 Western Showcase.
And you know the crew, you know, from Football Alberta, Football Canada, all working hard to, with all the football this week here in Edmonton. Tim Enger out to make these presentations to the players of the game. Again, it's been in communication with a lot of people, ironing out the kickoff times and start times.
James Drake with the offensive player of the game for Team Alberta. A few big plays from the wide receiver. Yeah, Tim Enger did not have an easy weekend.
No, it was not. We were texting and trying to figure out start times. Do we need camera guys, color guys? What's going on? Are these games going to be played? Fortunately, it did, and the boys made the most of it with a great game out here today to start this doubleheader.
And they'll give the Oceani defensive player to Ryan Tuzzi out of Archbishop O'Leary. Not often I get to call my alma mater.
Yeah, there you go.
Anderson Bicknell. Big contributions on the defensive side today for Team BC. You wonder if Rebel might have got it last game. Sometimes they give it to someone else.
Two dynamic athletes making plays, and so Chapman, well-deserving, of course,
for sure,
with the load he carried today and the work that he did to help this team, BC team, come back from a deficit late in this game and take the lead.
Chapman and Rebel both with huge games for that BC offense, both deserving. So BC will get their bronze medals, and that'll do it for our IC Live Procast of the bronze medal game. We're going to get off the air quickly because we got about 15 minutes to go till our next game. Team BC picks up the bronze medal.